Okay, let's see if that works. Does that work now? Can everybody hear me on that one? No sound.
No sound.
Bluetooth is off. Please help. Good day. Yep. Yes, yes, yes. They can hear us.
You hear us? Can you hear us now? Great. Awesome.
Okay.
Yeah, so we were cruising.
I don't think they're going to be able to hear you.
Hear me? Well, as long as they hear somebody.
All right, so let me say. We are on a cross-country road trip. Sam, the adventure man. We've got Dan, the cameraman. We are currently stuck in Morris, Illinois. We're supposed to be in Kokomo, Indiana tomorrow on a cold case that we're working. Good news is also is that we just got done shooting the snowcat video 2 days ago.
We recovered
the snowcat. So the snowcat is out. The video comes out tomorrow because Dan, the cameraman, on the road with us for 38 days. We have 38 more days that we're on the road. And Dan, the cameraman, has been working for 2 days to get that video out for you guys. 6 o'clock tomorrow morning, Pacific time.
Yep.
But right now, like, are any of you in Morris, Illinois by chance? And do you happen to have one or two spare trailer tires? Because what ended up happening was we did have a spare, and the spare yesterday replaced this tire because look at this tire, completely bald, so we were afraid to run this tire. So we put the spare tire on the other side. And then tonight, Sam was cruising down the freeway, ended up, sparks, there was a big jerk.
I'll tell him. Yeah, so big jerk, and then all of a sudden the sparks started flying. I thought it was a celebration from the snowcat, all the fireworks going off, but no, it was a blown tire, just rubbing the metal, causing sparks, pulled right over.
And so now we're at Walmart. We showed up at Walmart like 2 minutes after they closed, but I looked online though, and the problem is I don't think they sell the tires that we need in the morning. So we got to wait for another tire store to open up.
Yeah.
But we are 2 hours away from Kokomo, Indiana, where we need to be at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. We are not going to make that deadline.
No, not unless somebody helps us. So if anybody is near Morris, you guys have a spare, if you guys have a couple spares, whatever you guys have, please reach out to us. We'd greatly appreciate it. That gets us on the road to go help the next family.
Yep. And the best.
Here we are.
My family owns a trailer business and might have a dealer in the area. Like, nice. Yeah, but are they open tonight? Like, we're trying to get on the road tonight. In fact, we also did another cold case today. Unfortunately, we did not find him. It was $100,000 reward. So it's a real life treasure hunt. Let's tell them everything that we're actually doing for the next 38 days.
All right, we're here. Let's talk about it.
I'm going to go down the list. I can't see comments, so let me know if there's any good comments that I need so Dan will tell you.
Yeah, I'm watching comments too.
Okay, so let's just spend a little bit of time together this evening because.
Yeah, why not? We ain't got nothing else going
on. I think we got some time.
Yeah, that's great.
So it's an incredible road trip with these two. We did the snowcat. Follow along on this one. So we did the snowcat. Today we did Ethan in Hampton, Iowa. $100,000 reward if you can find them. Our video next week is going to show you all the places that he was not.
We got $2. Thanks, Kevin. That helps.
Thank you.
It really does. It can help us pay for a new tire. So thank you for sure, Kevin.
What size are the tires?
That's a good question. You want to throw some light on there?
I got some light here.
Here, we'll see if we can do it. They are 5-lug, and usually trailer tires, they also come like completely mounted sometimes. How come we can't tell a trailer size on here? I think it's all rubbed off over there.
DOT.
Oh yeah, see how worn off it is. The spare tire though might have a size on it.
Yeah, let's go check the other tire.
Let's keep telling them what else we're doing.
Yeah, tell them what we're doing.
So then after Kokomo, Indiana, tomorrow, we're then going to go to Pennsylvania. We have 5 days in Pennsylvania.
Oh, here we go.
It's a ST225-75R15, 5-lug. We need two new tires, because then we'll make this one a spare again, is what we need.
Yep. Anyway, Kokomo, Indiana, as you were saying.
Yes, Kokomo, Indiana. And then we're going to Quakertown. Mm-hmm. And I'm just going to throw that out there. If anybody wants to meet up with us along the way, I'm like, what is the best way for us to actually let them know where we're going to be? I mean, it's really difficult.
Yeah.
I'm just going to tell you the locations. And if you happen to be in that location, you like want to come hang out, then you have to send me like a private message over on or Mr. Lysik on
Facebook.
On Facebook.
That's probably
yeah,
the best.
That's the best way. After, after Kokomo, Indiana, we're going to Quakertown. There's a quarry over there with 10 to 15 cars over there.
That the one with the huge granite walls?
No, not yet. We haven't gotten to that one yet. Okay. Uh-huh. So with the Quakertown 10 to 15 cars in the quarry, we're doing it on the 27th and 28th. You want to go grab my computer? That way I can kind of go down the list of everything that we have going on. So 27th, 28th, 29th, we're doing that in Quakertown. Then on the 30th, you guys are going to love this. On the 30th, who has been saying, you're watching comments?
Yep.
You turned it off.
I'm coming back to the comments. Right. Coming back to the comments. People are saying.
So, you guys have been saying, Jared, you need to get yourself an ROV.
Yes.
An underwater drone. Well, guess what? We have a new sponsor coming on board, and that's one of the reasons why we're going all the way from Oregon to Pennsylvania, because, I don't know, it's like a $45,000 or an $80,000 drone. I don't know which one, but it's like super impressive. Underwater drone with sonar, with a claw on it as well, Dan. So we've got that going on.
Awesome.
Then...
like an underwater, just come and grab you type
thing. Yes, it'll actually like recover and help you. So then after, don't show them like everything I've got. Just read it to me. So bring up right over here. Yeah, we got like private stuff on there. So that is, and then October 1st, Dan, we're going to Vermont. There is a cold case up there and a 600 foot deep, Sam, 600 feet deep is a granite rock quarry that we're going to.
That's the cool one. I'm real excited about that one. I'm excited about all of them, especially that one.
Yeah, the walls are like straight up and down, 600 feet. Like, and we have, and
Are we telling them what we're looking for, or is?
Yeah, it's a homicide.
Yeah.
So we're going for a homicide on that one. It's 3 months old, and then in addition to that, after that, then we come back to the mystery hole. There's a mystery hole in.
It says use AAA. Says
will they give me a new tire?
It says use AAA towing if you
I don't have AAA, but
I have AAA.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, my mom got it for me for my birthday.
Will they give us two new tires?
I don't know. I'll call and find out.
We need a new rim though. The rim is toast.
Toasted. Yep, yeah. It's done for.
And they're also gonna be like, hey, you have a spare, so you really don't need a tire now. Because the other one's because you have two tires that are inflated.
I don't know. It's worth a call. We'll see.
I have Progressive. I don't know if they're any good. So anyway, then after Vermont, we're going to the mystery hole. Now, the mystery hole, we are told that it was part of a whole bank robbery and some other stuff, that we may actually have an armored car in the bottom at Nottingham Park in Oxford, Pennsylvania.
In Nottingham. All right.
I feel like I haven't told you everything about this trip.
You haven't told me about that one. An armored car?
Yes.
With money in it?
I'm thinking they probably already took the money out of it.
Like some Robin Hood type stuff right there, man.
Uh-huh. Okay. And then after
AAA has tires and rims. I keep getting that in the comments.
Really?
I'm gonna call AAA. I'm gonna call my AAA right now.
Yeah, see if
thank
we can
you
that.
Guys. I'm gonna call and see. And thanks again, Mom, for the AAA.
Yes.
It's a good gift. I've used it twice. This will be the third time this year.
So after the mystery hole, this is the one that I'm not just gonna say I'm most excited about this one. I'm excited about it. We have six cars, six that have already been identified in the river, Dan. And part of this is not just the cars that we're going for, but one of those cars is supposed to contain a 17-year-old young man who went 3, 4, 5 months ago now. He is, Nicholas is his name. He took his mom's car, took a .22 rifle. I think he recently broke up with his girlfriend as well. And I don't think he took the rifle to, you know, I think that he took the rifle to sell for gas money, because I think he was supposed to go up to Springfield, Illinois, is also a rumor, from North Carolina. I don't know if that's true or not, though, but the fire department there has reached out to me and said, hey, we would really love for you to come down. So we're going down to North Carolina.
Thank you for choosing AAA.
Well, you can wait. I mean, we're still talking for like the next 20 minutes.
You think so?
Yeah.
Hey, we just gotta call
okay, yeah, you do your thing. Yeah, we'll see.
Okay. I'll let you know.
Well, you still got to listen to what's going on here.
I'll be back here. I'll be back.
Okay. Then after that, we're going to meet up with Nug, Exploring with Nug.
Exploring with Nug.
He has a YouTube channel, so if you've not checked him out, he finds guns all the time. We're going to go for a semi-truck, a 22,000-pound semi-truck.
That's cool.
Because, you know what, now that we got the Snowcat at 15,000 pounds, and we have our new custom lift bags that I made them personally. We can lift anything up to like 40,000 pounds now.
Are we going to tell them about the helicopter?
Well, I think you just told them about the helicopter. But we're not to that yet because we still have like a car and some other.
Yeah, so I'm excited about that one though.
Other stuff that we're doing with Nug. And then let me go down my list.
I'm excited about Nug too. Nug,
yeah,
good dude.
And then, yeah, then we're going to Lake Cumberland. Oh, wait. Yeah, so this semi-truck. And then we're going to Lake Cumberland, Kentucky, where we possibly have a semi-truck there.
And a helicopter.
And a helicopter. The helicopter is an
R-22. There we go.
Okay.
Yeah.
Helicopter, it's been underwater for 10 years. It was involved in a poker run, which would, like when the boats go and do their little race. And the rumor is it came around, it caught its skid, and no. The people did not die on that one. So the good news, they got out of that one. But then we have more cold cases. Let me see what else we have going. Oh, and then we have.
Where are we in again?
We're in Morris, Illinois. So if anybody has some spare trailer tires in Morris, Illinois, come meet up with us right now. Somebody keeps saying Truck Stop has truck tires and wheels at legal robbery prices. That's perfect. Yes, robbery. I'm not looking for robbery prices tonight. So update your description. What do I have on my description? I don't know how to update my description while I'm online, though.
Whoever helps gets two free shirts.
You're giving away shirts?
Yeah.
We do have shirts.
Two free shirts.
Yes. I have some spare
Can
trailer
we
tires.
Can a comment?
Can we pin it?
Can we, like, make a comment and then pin it?
I don't know. Like, what do you want me to say?
I don't know.
Live chat, super chat, some messages. I have no idea.
This is just
What I don't want to do is, like, kill it.
Yeah.
Let's keep going down the list of what we have going on in this 2020 road trip tour. Then we have... Oh, and then we have a gentleman... Dan, who is missing with this one. This one is kind of a sad story. He worked for 38 years, Dan.
Okay.
Arthritis, pain, eventually unemployment, and his work said, you cannot work anymore. And the pain was so great that one day he just ended up leaving his house without his shoes, without his wallet, and without his medication. The car is now gone. There's a boat ramp near his house. And with that, there's three cars that have already been identified. The local authorities are not doing anything to check out this location. And the family has reached out to us. And so we're meeting up with Christine, his wife, to go see if we can find Will or Bill. So we have three cars there. Plus, we hope to get Bill out of the river there. Then after that, where are we going? So after Nashville, then we're going to, I'm really excited about Lake of the Ozarks.
Oh, yeah.
Tell me, there is a rumor about a boat that is 60 feet deep that has four people on board. And I don't know how to handle this one. So, I mean, get in the comments down below. Like, I really want feedback on this one. The authorities have told... some of the people there, leave this boat alone. There's four people on board, okay? They have no next of kin. There was no insurance.
Thanks, the Jedi, he gave us 400.
Oh, thanks. Oh, that's huge, man.
Thank you very much. Now, check that. Sometimes it just tricks us because it's like in pesos or something like that. So, see if that's legit. I mean, if not, that'll really pay for tires. Appreciate that.
Thank you.
100%. Thank you. So anyway, tell me how to handle this. Like, do I call the national news before we even go on it? Like, this is one of those things that where we could actually get arrested for going on this. If we bring up something that, so the authorities have specifically... And here's the thing, the reason why is because as we've experienced across the U.S., agencies don't have money or the resources to handle this kind of stuff.
Finally getting through.
Okay. So, agencies don't have it. And so because of that, they like to, it's out of sight, out of mind. They like to sweep it under the rug.
Yes, we are.
Because if they were to pay a salvage company to bring this boat up, I mean, they're into it for like $20,000 to $50,000 to $60,000 for this specific boat. Plus, then they got to do all the paperwork and, the bones and everything. So here's their excuse. Are you ready for this? They said that the cabin is pressurized and that if you bring it up from 60 feet, that the bodies will implode. Okay, listen, I'm a diver. I've experienced it, the bodies, and you, anybody that likes to watch my channel for a while, the bodies are not going to implode, especially after 3 years of being underwater. The cabin is not pressurized. The cabin has the exact same pressure of anything else underwater. Do we first contact like the national news and like we bring them in on it? I mean, we're going to identify that the boat is, in fact, the boat has already been identified. Like, I have a contact there at Lake of the Ozarks, and they have identified the boat has not moved. It is still there. And I don't think that anybody's gotten the bodies. Also in Lake of the Ozarks, Dan, we have a Jeep that a police chief is now dead. He's gone. But the rumor is that the Jeep that's in Lake of the Ozarks was his Jeep, and that he intentionally put it there because he couldn't pay for it. So we're talking like insurance fraud. Uh-huh. But he is dead now. So he's not going to, you know, get in trouble, but we are going to be searching for that Jeep. Also in Lake of the Ozarks, we have another vehicle underwater with a person in it that has been identified. So we are going for that one. After Lake of the Ozarks, where are we going? We might be hitting, between Cumberland, Kentucky and Nashville, we might be going to Bowling Green on October 13th.
Let's give an update for people that just joined the chat, what's going on.
Okay, so those of you who just joined the chat, we are stuck in Morris, Illinois is where we're stuck because of Sam. And the reason for it is because yesterday, we stopped for gas. We realized that this tire was wearing really weird. It is only bald from here to here. So we ended up taking this tire off, and it was on the other side. We ended up putting the spare tire on. So that's our spare tire. And then today, Sam, because he was driving, so we blame him.
Yep, whoever touched it last.
Yep. That tire ended up blowing. Sparks went all over. It tore off our lighting and everything. That is now toast. So we tried to get to Walmart before they closed because sometimes I know that Walmart has tires and rims, but then I went online and they actually don't have any. So even when they open at 7, it's not going to help us out at all. And we need to be in Kokomo, Indiana, tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. for a missing persons case. Which, by the way, I didn't even tell them what that one was about. That's a 18-year-old missing teen, and supposedly she got in a little bit of trouble with her drug dealer, or stole from him, is the story that I have, and they gave her a hot shot, which means they gave her extra drugs intentionally in order to kill her.
Oh, man.
Lowered out the motel window, is what we've been told, and never to be seen again. So we have a couple of locations tomorrow that are all water related to go check on that one. So that's kind of brings you up to speed. Anybody that's just now coming on kind of need to go back and check out some of the past video to get caught up on it.
And I'm on phone with AAA trying to see if they'll help us at all.
Yes, because you guys have been...
A lot of you guys suggested that we call, so I'm calling. And again, thanks Mom for the membership.
Yep. Then after that, I gotta tell people about after Lake of the Ozarks. Okay, this is, and I'm not gonna tell the location on this one, but this is the jailhouse rumor. This is an incredible story. Late one night, I get a phone call, and they said, "Is this Jared?" I said, "Yes, this is Jared." They said, "Jared with Adventures of Purpose?" I said, "Yes, it is." They said, "Is this being recorded?" I'm like, no. I'm like, no, it's not being recorded. But my wife and my daughter are on speaker. I said, he goes, okay, that's fine, but it's not being recorded. I said, no, sir, it's not being recorded at all. And so with that, he went on to tell me about, you know, he's like, I'm 73 or 78 years old now. Somebody has to know the story so that way you can help the family. And I said, help the family. I said, are we dealing with a homicide? He said, yes. And it goes on that supposedly, and he goes on to tell me like, hey, it was a dark and stormy, I'm not kidding you at all. Like he really said, it was a dark and stormy night in Missouri. And if you know anything about the storms, and so then he tells me, you know, you have to go so many miles outside of town. It's gonna be on the right-hand side. There's a road, you go down, there's three tin sheds.
Is this Highway 6?
Yes, Highway 6.
Yeah, it's Highway 6.
Yep. So anyway, and I did, and he's like, I didn't, I'm telling you, I didn't do it. But if I did do it, you're going to go 50 feet past those three tin sheds, is what he told me, to the north, mm-hmm. because it's 230 feet deep. Now, because we have the new underwater drone that we're picking up next week, we can use that underwater drone to go down 230 feet to see if that car is there. And because it's going to have some retrieval tools and a claw,
the arm,
yeah, we're able to actually hook onto that car. And then we can do a staged lift, Sam, and bring the car up if the car is there. I think, and now I'm not going to say, I don't know if the guy that called me is, you know, actually watching or not. Did I hit a button that I wasn't supposed to? I don't know. Is everybody still there? I can't see anything now.
I think so.
Okay. Somebody comment. I don't see anything going on. How do I look at comments now?
Press the comment thing, that thing.
Hit that thing?
And then live chat.
So we had a
live chat. Okay, there it is. Okay, now I can see him again. So anyway, I told my wife, I said, this guy totally did it. And she's like, I don't think he did it. Okay, anyway, so we're going to follow up on that cold case.
All right.
After that, then that's in Missouri. And then after that, we have Randy Leach over in Kansas. So a lot of you reached out to me about...
That's a no-go. AAA said they'd just tow.
Truck stop in Morris, Illinois shows they do emergency roadside tire help.
Yeah, that's gonna be like $500 for a $50 tire. Trust me, we don't want to do an emergency roadside in Morris.
Yeah, we can do it. I'll save the number if it comes down to it.
Yeah.
I mean, we did just get a nice donation though.
Yeah. Well, but that doesn't cover the $500 emergency tire, so we can wait till morning. It's just gonna put us behind.
All right, well, I have the number saved
okay.
when it comes down to that.
So back to Randy Leach. He's been missing for 30 years. Parents are getting older. A lot of you have reached out and told us about this Randy Leach case. So we're going to go see if we can find Randy Leach. His parents are getting older. He was an only child. Went missing after a graduation party. So it was graduation is when he went. I mean, can you imagine? Like, he's graduating. A good time in his life.
Yeah, it's wild.
Dad's health is failing, and like I said, I've spoken with his mom, and I've spoken with friends of his as well. Friends of hers, so friends of the family. And then we have a friend over at Lake of the Ozarks who you're going to see him in the snowcat video tomorrow.
Tony is awesome. Tony. This guy just jumped in. Got himself all muddy and dirty, no fear. He's an awesome dude. Thank you, Tony. You guys will see him tomorrow when the snowcat video gets released.
But I have a story to tell about Tony.
You do?
So, yeah, so he actually came to Colorado to meet up with us on the snowcat, and on his way over, he ran into a sheriff from another county, and the sheriff said, what are you doing? Like, somehow they struck up a conversation, and the sheriff said, we have surveillance, and we know for a fact there are 20 to 25 cars in our lake right here. He told him what the lake was. And of those 20 vehicles, 5 of them, the sheriff knows for sure, has bodies in them.
So we're going to be busy.
So again, we're dealing with a small county mm-hmm. that doesn't have the dive resources. And so because of that, you know what they told him? They said that the bottom of the lake is too, what's the word I'm looking for? Is... Like too dangerous. It's too dangerous to dive down there. There's too much debris that you're going to get entangled and you can't pull anything out of there. Mm-hmm. But the sheriff does want us to come pull stuff out because he knows that like we can do it.
Yeah, we do that. That's what we do.
Uh-huh. But they don't have the resources. So that's the thing. After that, we might have a few days left. We're going to Atchison.
How do you say that?
Oh, wait, no. Before that, we're going to Sugar Creek, Missouri.
Sugar Creek.
There's 5 cars over there. Mm-hmm. And then we're going back over to Kansas because this one is kind of, I mean, they're all sad stories whenever we're dealing with people. Billy Bob, I cannot make that up. Billy Bob and Mary.
Mary Sue?
Mary. I don't know what that one is. High school sweethearts, they were in their like 72, 73 years old when they both went missing. And really the feeling around town and supposedly some other family members is they just simply got old and decided that they were going to go out together. And there's been a couple of cars that have been identified in the river. Mm-hmm. And one of those cars is believed to be Billy Bob and Mary.
Mary, yeah.
So, I mean, it's a sad thing.
They went out together.
They did go out together. Oh. That's where we're at. on this evening and everything we have going on.
You see anything in the comments?
There's a lot.
Yeah. So, yep, Walmart's closed.
Yeah.
But this one here shut down the tire shop.
Yeah, so the tire shop's not even open at this one in the morning.
Yeah, we looked and the tire shop's already shut down, even though we were like 2 minutes late getting here.
Yeah.
It wouldn't have done any good. The next shop, what do you say, it opens at 8 in the morning? But we need to be in Kokomo at 9. And Kokomo is like an hour or
137 miles
away.
And in rush hour traffic.
Rush hour. We're not doing that with this.
Yeah.
It's not happening.
Yep.
So
somebody said we need to check the bearings. I did grease the bearings before we came on this trip, but I don't know if like the bearings are shot. I don't think that the bearings are shot. Like I said, I greased it. The trailer itself. Now check this out on what we got going on. We've got the Bini. So because of all of you, like we started this channel 2 years ago, and listen, I'm going to be completely real with you guys. I could barely afford air to dive, Sam.
I heard you were diving without a pressure gauge.
I didn't have a pressure gauge either. I had no dive computer.
No, nothing.
No, I did not. And because of the viewers being here, all messages are visible here. Let me throw that back up. Because of you guys, the viewers, and your support and being here, just watching, just commenting, subscribing, sharing, the donations that are coming in this evening, because of you guys has made all of this possible the last 2 years. Like, I'm blown away that we are able to come out here on a cross-country road trip for 40 days to serve others.
So Loves has tire repair and they come to you. That's probably like $1 million though.
At least a million. We're gonna need more donations on that one. So anyway, so where I was going with this is it's amazing that we went from barely being able to afford air to not even knowing how much air that we had in our dive tanks to, look at this. We picked up a 1999 Mini Winnebago RV for $14,500 because of you guys made this possible. It's a nice little 31-foot, so I got my little room in the back, and we got Dan that sleeps on the couch, and Sam, that's his bed up there, he's sleeping up above.
I have a little cubby.
Yeah, this thing is getting 6.94 miles to the gallon. Let that sink in, Sam. That kind of hurts. Wait, somebody said Lowe's and Home Depot and Bi-Mart, Jared. Chris said that. They have tires for this, Chris?
I don't think Bi-Mart's open this late.
Yeah, I don't
think so. We are in Morris, Illinois. We have a Dan Schmidt Media that's in Morris, Illinois. Dan Schmidt Media, do you have tires? Do you have rims?
Oh, wait, there he is right there.
Wait, dude,
that's Dan Schmidt Media.
People are like, where are you? I forgot your last name.
I got so excited, man.
Yeah. So anyway,
Dan Schmidt Media, check him out.
Yeah. So coming back to my thank you and appreciation to all of you. The RV is possible because of you. The trailer itself was we inherited that from my father-in-law, who is no longer with us. Same thing with my mother-in-law. So the tires are at least 15 to 20 years old, Sam. Something like that.
What'd you say?
The tires. We inherited this trailer
okay.
from Kristen's parents. And so the tires are like 10, 15, 20 years old to begin with.
So, yeah,
it was due that they were both going to go eventually.
Right, here it is.
Anyway, with that, the trailer's definitely packed. I mean, we've got, you'll see it in a lot of the videos, but you know, again, because of you and the sponsors and the viewers and everybody that participates, all of this, like I said, I had one dive tank, Sam. Mm-hmm. We now have 20 dive tanks. We can now pay for gas. We can now do the cross-country road trip, donate our time and our services.
All because of you guys.
100%.
All because of you guys.
Yep.
Sharing, liking, subscribing, commenting,
all the things. It doesn't change the fact, though, Sam, that you're the reason why we're stuck tonight.
No. Yeah, I guess the last person that touched it, you're the guilty one.
Yeah, you were driving.
I was driving when it happened, so it's totally my fault.
Yep. In other news also, we're just killing time at this point. If you have any questions, please ask them of me. We have plenty of time this evening. It's, almost 11 o'clock in Morris, Illinois?
Yeah, it's 11 o'clock.
Yeah, midnight on the East Coast. So any questions, make sure that you tell me if there's any questions. What else did I want to say? There was something else that I really wanted to share.
Check out Sam the Adventure Man. That must have been it.
100%. And Sam, definitely check out Sam because Sam's recording videos of the same stories and cars and cases and cold cases that we're on, but he's recording it as Sam grows as a person and his YouTube channel, is I think that on this trip it's going to be more of a behind the scenes of what's happening at the same time of what we're recording on Adventures with Purpose. And then we have the benefit of now having Dan, the cameraman, who is helping out with camera work as well as, but this boy has been busy
the whole time.
How many hours did you put into that snowcat video?
Probably at least 20.
Yeah, 20 hours. He turned out that snowcat video in 20 hours. That's gonna drop tomorrow morning, which is gonna burn up my data plan to get this thing.
10.3 gigabytes.
Yeah, so I still have to upload that.
4 minutes long.
Yeah, so I still have to upload that tonight.
Jared,
so,
you look amazing, by the way, on your weight loss journey.
Thank you, everybody. Speaking of weight loss journey,
I started today. I'm hanging with him. He said I have to eat what he eats, do what he does, and we'll see what happens.
So my goal in the next 38 more days is down another 10 to 12 pounds. I think that you're shooting for 15 yourself.
Yeah, 15.
And so as an example of today's eating menu, we started off this morning with some oatmeal mixed with some nut butter and some blueberries. In addition to that, for breakfast, we had some tofu with some egg whites, with some yams, with some leftover veggies from a Mexican burrito. What else was in there? And guacamole.
Yep.
So that was the breakfast this morning.
Yeah, we had that weird little shake.
We had a weird shake. Our magic bullet was missing the blade, so we weren't able to do our regular shake that we were supposed to. And then for dinner, though, I'm going to say dinner, Sam, was amazing.
Yo, dinner was awesome.
Oh, yeah.
Dinner was spectacular.
We had four ounces of salmon.
Uh-huh. It was great.
And then I'm also told with a private message that I should show some fancy new air compressors from Tony, the Tony man at Lake of the Ozarks. He's amazing.
He just sent you a message?
Yeah, he came to, and you can barely see him, they're back.
I'll put the light on. I got a light here.
Wait, you're still not going to see him. They're so far buried in there. No. But yeah, we had another donation from the amazing Tony, Lake of the Ozarks, who donated two new air compressors for us. But I still need to, because of the video ray that we're picking up, the ROV drone, requires a 3,000 watt air compressor. I'm sorry, generator, just to run that.
Oh, that must be a serious piece of machinery.
Yeah, and so I need to get a new generator in the next 2 or 3 days, that will.
Yeah.
Take care of that. Yes. What am I trying to say? So we need a 3,000 watt generator, but that will only run one of those air compressors that Tony gave us. Tony gave us two air compressors, but they have such a draw. We need like a 6,000 watt generator for that. I'm running out of space. Like, I upgraded from that other trailer. So Matt Moss gave us the other trailer, and then it got too small. So then I had to steal my wife's parents' trailer that we ended up inheriting. So my wife is actually, I don't know if she's on here or not. Honey, I love you. Thank you for supporting me and Sam and this entire trip, and to my girls as well. But anyway, so I know that she's a little upset with me because I did steal the family trailer that they were using for like bicycle storage and stuff like that. So eventually we're going to have to upgrade the trailer as well.
Man, Jacob's just blowing up our feed. He's all over the place.
Don't even mention him. You know that Jacob was actually invited to come on this trip and he said no. In fact, think about that.
Wait, what's Jacob's
Wait. Somebody says, why are you coming to Bowling Green? Steve, we're coming to Bowling Green because there's cars in your river there. So that's why we're going there. Now, Chaos Divers, okay? Should I do a little tour? You guys want to see where we're actually staying and what we're doing here?
Let me go in front.
Is there anything? I mean, there's nothing that shouldn't be out, right?
Everything's good.
All right.
Everything.
Sounds good.
Let's turn these lights on so you can see how we're living.
Yeah. So anyway, so Jacob, Chaos Divers, had the opportunity that this was going to be...
This could have been you, bro.
I mean, normally it's a couch, but it's the bed now.
Yeah, you could have laid like this.
Yep. However, he was so indecisive, couldn't make the decision to come with us, and I'm really glad... let me tell you how glad I am that Jacob did not come. Because if Jacob would have come, Dan, the cameraman, would not have been here. 100% guaranteed he would not have been here. So, Jacob, thank you for not taking a road trip with us, because now we got Dan, the cameraman, is sleeping there. We've got Sam, the adventure man, who... How do you even sleep up there with all that stuff?
I don't know. I just kind of throw it. It's like
It's like a hug. It just kind of cuddles me.
Yeah. This does slide out, but because we've been actually traveling late at night, like we got in at 5 o'clock this morning into Hampton, Iowa. We were supposed to get in at like midnight, 1 o'clock in the morning into Kokomo. And really we have no time off. Like we're just,
we do
the job during the day and then we drive for a couple of hours at night. Anyway, our nice little storage, we've got, you know, I mean, like I said, we're just sharing tonight. You know, we've got all the protein stuff up there, all of our dishes and whatnot there, little sinks and cupboards, little stove here, a couple of spices. And as far as spices, we don't have like a whole lot. We have like a lot of gum, barbecue seasoning, coconut oil, a little salt and pepper, and some sugar. So that's really the amount of spices that we have. Let's see, what else we got? We got an old school TV from 1999, microwave. We got AC in here, which Dan, you love that AC today.
Yeah, it's super nice.
Yeah. And then as we roll back to my little bedroom back here, I got my little quarters back here. During the day, I kind of turn it into like a little charging station. And then I've got like a charging station here. And yeah, it actually has a lot of space back here, Sam.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Yep. And then we do have our little...
Go in here, I'll show you this. Yeah.
Well, don't show them how to use it.
No, yeah. Put the lights on here.
Yeah, so our little bathroom here. You got to turn the light on. No, that's right.
There we go.
Okay.
We have, so... That's a little bathroom.
Yep.
We might have someone that can help.
What? What? We do? I knew if we stayed on long enough, we might. Anyway, then we have our little shower over here, and right now I'm just kind of letting my dry suit.
Yeah, I'm gonna walk by. I want to see who might be able to help. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, yeah. Go check out the comments.
See what Dan Schmidt is talking about.
Okay. A Ness, did you get my comments? I only live 40 minutes away, but can't get there till 2 or 3 a.m. If you guys can wait. I have the tires. Holy yes, yeah, Kalina. Yeah,
2 or 3 a.m. is way better than like 8 or 9.
Because then we can still make our appointment at 9 a.m. Because we're meeting up with Jerry, who is the grandma of Karina. We're also meeting up with Pamela. I forget her last name, but she's a viewer who lives in Kokomo. So she's meeting up with us as well. Drying a dry suit. Hold on. Oh, wait. I can't read everything that's going on.
Yes, drying a dry suit. That's how we do it.
Yeah. Let's see. I don't know the best. I'm not following in these comments. So you guys need to stay on top of the comments. Okay.
When will you be in Vermont?
Vermont, October 1st and 2nd. We're going to be in Vermont. Welcome to come hang out with us. As far as other stuff, you know, we're all about like the, almond milk or oat milk. We don't have many condiments. We have, because we are driving late at night, we do have some energy drinks, some oat milk there. And we're really trying
Jared, how should ANS contact you? Email?
Yeah.
Or through your Facebook?
Yeah, do it through Facebook, through Mr. No, I don't know. I don't know the best way.
Either way, try both.
Try both?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm going to answer it. Yeah,
do the Facebook thing.
Yeah, send me a Facebook messenger on Mr. Lysak, and then I'll get a hold of you. I'll give you my personal cell phone number.
Thanks for the donation, Tommy. Appreciate your service.
Thank you, Tommy.
That's awesome, man. Thank you.
Yeah, oh, a disabled vet, huh? Yeah, thank you. I don't have much cash. 100%. I know that sometimes it's a struggle for people to share, and some people do extra like that. And Tommy... Thank you very much. It does mean the world to us. So thank you on that one.
Would it ever be possible for us to go to Canada?
100% once the borders open back up.
Yeah, we're there.
But we were supposed to actually go to Cornwall, Ontario, Canada on this trip, but it got closed down.
Brandon Hancock says he wants to hang. All right, we'll catch up with us somewhere.
Yeah. So the best thing to do is send me a message over on Mr. Lysak, and then we can connect and we can coordinate some stuff. Anyway, back to our little food. We have hard-boiled eggs. We got some oatmeal. There's really no junk food in here. Because, Sam?
Catherine McCartan, thanks for the donation. Appreciate you helping us, keep gas in the RV and moving along.
Other food in here? We got spinach. We got eggs. A little bit of cheese. Why is there cheese in here? We're not supposed to have cheese.
I don't know how it got there.
Mm-hmm. All right. Okay. And there is some pizza in here. We did have pizza a couple days ago because it was my 45th birthday. I didn't buy the pizza. My father bought it, and his wife and little baby brother, Elijah, who is in the snowcat video. So anyway, so they did a pizza party for us. And it was also, but we also get a treat and recover, or not, yeah, we get a treat.
Treat day.
A treat meal and recovery. And we have another viewer also is sending us a gift card for Olive Garden on our treat day.
Oh, that's great. Thank you.
Somehow, I guess you can email gift cards.
I didn't know that. I got a direct question here. It says, Sam, how do you get certified as a diver? Yeah, so check out, flip it around me. There we go. Yeah, so what's this guy's name? James M. Cooper. Look up or Google, you know, local dive shops. Contact those guys. Go check them out, and they'll get you on your way. James M. Cooper, what area do you live? Do you live in the Puget Sound? If you do, maybe you come hang with me.
Yeah, we really do have a open door policy. I mean, we give you the dates.
Yeah, if you're cool,
as to where we're at.
If you're cool, come hang.
And that's what I also tell people
too.
Don't
be creepy.
I say, listen, at the end of the day, if you want to come hang with us, it's an open door policy. You can't be. Can I say this? I normally don't say this.
I'll say it.
It's still a family channel, and it's not like a bad word. I just say, you can't be a dick. If you want to come hang with us, don't be a dick. We're out to have a good time. There is no real leader in what we do. We listen to people and...
Yeah, we just kind of just go along.
We have a good time.
We do, absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely.
What else do we want to do? Will you be in Maryland? No, no Maryland. Are you coming to Louisiana? Where's Louisiana at?
Where's Louisiana? It's down like south.
Yeah.
Kind of by Florida.
Oh, what state?
Louisiana. What state is Louisiana?
Oh, well, that's a state. Never mind. No. Jeez. We're going to Pennsylvania, Vermont, North Carolina, Georgia, Kentucky, Tennessee. No Louisiana. No Arkansas. Once in a while, we might be in California, but mainly Northern California is where that one's at. Sorry, you guys are broke down. I'm actually reading comments now also.
Yeah,
hey, it's Michelle. That's Michelle from
the other day.
Oh, yes. Michelle,
yeah, that's awesome.
How you doing? I'm sorry I didn't get to sign your shirt when you met up with us in Island Lake. You actually made it into our video. You're going to be in the snowcat video tomorrow.
And thanks for the food.
Oh, Michelle brought us some food. So an incredible viewer, Michelle, who is also a YouTube sponsor. So we do have a donation from her every single month.
Happy belated birthday, Jared.
Thank you, sir. And with that, if you are a member, you know, you're supporting the channel, you're part of the team, and as such, when we can, we do videos early. The snowcat video, I'm sorry you're not getting early because we late. Dan, turn that
quick
one
turn
fast.
Around.
So anyway, Michelle, thank you for that, and look for your little cameo in tomorrow's video.
It's awesome.
Yep.
Let's also give a shout out to Josh Miner.
Josh,
doing our music. He's doing our custom.
Is he online right now?
Yeah, he's in the chat.
He's in the chat?
Yeah.
Josh Miner. Okay, so let me tell you about Josh. Josh is a music producer, does incredible tracks, and he said, Jared, listen, I know you have a hard time finding music on Artlist. I know that sometimes we edit. And sometimes we spend more time looking for music.
But music's everything.
Yes, than editing. And I know that some of you have hated like my music selection. And then when Sam was editing, not this Sam, but a different Sam was editing for me, and as well as you, people notice the difference. They're like, oh, hey, the music sounds good now this time. Okay, they hate it when I pick the music. And so we have Josh Miner, thank you very much, who has created like a whole library for us. How many songs has he put in there in the last week?
40, 50?
Yeah, 40 or 50 songs that he's put in there for tracks that we're starting to use. But also, Josh is going to be to where you're not even going to have to put music in there anymore, because Josh is coming on board and he says, I just want to be a part of what is you're doing. I want to be a part of the team. And with that, he's going to start doing some full scores. So like that, and what that means is Dan will edit the video and then Josh will come in behind it and just do all the music based upon what he's watching in the video. Like this is real legit episode type stuff. Like, because Josh has also worked on MTV with Jersey Shore.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What other episodes? I know he's done a couple of them.
We got a super cool one coming up that we probably shouldn't tell you about, but just know it's coming.
What are we talking about?
I don't know.
Oh no, we can tell them about that one.
I don't know. We should ask if they want to hear about it.
Yeah, do you get? Yeah,
do you guys want to hear about it, or should we just wait and surprise?
No, we're gonna go ahead and tell them. Josh has also put together. Listen, I'm like old school. I'm old, okay. And who here remembers the Muppets moving right along? Like moving right along. Fancy free. How does it really go?
It goes footloose and fancy free.
Footloose and fancy free.
Getting there is half the fun. Come share it with me.
Yes.
Moving right along.
So we're gonna do. Actually, we've turned Dan. This is Dan's little pet project for us. So Josh has cut the music for us. So it's not copyright infringement. Nope. And Dan is going to produce this 100%, putting together bits and pieces of our 2020 road trip the next 38 days. So because you don't have enough to do as it is to begin with. So this is like our little fun. That means that you and I are going to have to sing too.
Yeah, that's okay.
Yeah.
But it might not be pretty, but it'll definitely
it
be
is not gonna, it's going to be fun.
It'll be fun.
So that's going to be coming out at the very end. Sometime in November on that one.
Nautica, thanks for the donation. $20. Yes. Appreciate that.
Thank you very much. So, Josh, thank you very much for being a part of the team and helping us in that way that you've really helped us bring up our production value. It means that we won't be using like Epidemic Sound or Artlist or anything. Like, we're going straight to you. In addition to that, I understand that you are also putting together a royalty-free music library over on YouTube that people can follow you and download royalty-free music as new YouTubers. I know how much that really means to people because I started off as I couldn't afford anything.
Man, this is super cool, man. So, you got people from New Zealand, from Costa Rica. I'm just curious, where's everybody from? I mean, I want to know where all the fans, all the people,
Thanks, Todd.
Where are you guys from? Let's hear it.
Yeah, we got a Todd that donated.
Yeah, Todd donated $5.
Nice. Thank you, Todd.
Come to Michigan someday.
Yeah, not on this trip. So yeah, Nautica, thank you very much. Love the work you guys do. Love to watch. Can't wait one day catch up with you guys. And then did Todd say anything on his? You just read that one. So yeah, thanks. So if you plan on doing any YouTube, you're looking for royalty-free music, I know how difficult it is, so that way you don't get your stuff demonetized. Josh is going to have a special library and starting tomorrow. Well, wait a minute, Josh. You haven't even sent me the link for your new YouTube channel yet. So as soon as he does,
he said he will.
Okay, yeah. So I'll make sure that it's in tomorrow's Snowcat video moving forward that you can check out Josh's link YouTube to go get yourself some free music, and to inquire about his paid services as well. So all right, Josh, we're done talking about you. We're gonna move on to the next subject.
Should we re-up on what we're doing for all the people that just came on?
Yeah. So those that just came on, Sam broke us down. Because yesterday,
I was the last person touched it. So
were you driving when I checked the? No, I was driving the first time.
Yeah, you're driving the first time. Okay. You didn't actually have the blowout like I did with all the sparks flying.
And why didn't we have the blowout when I was driving?
Because you were setting me up. That's why.
No, it's because I got out after like 1,000 miles of driving. It was late at night, and I checked the tires. So I walked around. I checked the tires, and in doing so, I identified that this tire, it was actually on the other side. And right here, just in this section, you can see how it's bald right there. And it was on the other side, so I took that one off and we put the spare tire on. So we have the spare tire here. We took that tire from right there and we put the spare tire on here. We put that tire in the back of the trailer. It was done for. And the other tire still looked good, but then somewhere along the way, Sam ended up blowing the tire. Sam, where'd you go? And he like completely destroyed the tire. And he didn't just destroy the tire, but he destroyed the tire. It destroyed the lights up there. Look, my lights are gone. I got to repair those now. The rim is completely toast. Like, we can't use that rim at all. Like,
that's done.
Like, oh, yeah. I mean, it's bent, too. Like, you bent the rim. Sparks were flying everywhere. I wish
We should sign it. Give it away.
I wish I could actually have seen the sparks going. That does.
We do have a few more thank yous. Thanks, Ant, for your donation. As well as
Jamie,
thank you. God bless you and all you do. Thank you, Jamie.
Appreciate that.
And Nick.
Thank you, Nick Ray Abbott. Thank you from England.
England. Oh, look at that. That's the Euros.
Can you speak English?
I could speak Canadian English.
Uh-huh.
Australian English, American English, the Queen's English.
He's from England, so that's the Queen, right?
Yeah.
But wait a minute. Didn't they get rid of the Queen?
get rid of the queen?
I don't know.
Let's ask.
Yeah, tell us. Nick, do you guys still have a queen? Or I thought that like the prince had to pay back like a couple million and there's no longer a queen.
I have a hard enough time following in my own country, so my apologies if I don't know what's going on in yours.
Yes, but do tell us.
tell us.
And you're going to have to keep up on the comments on that one, Dan.
Chaos Divers, $2.99. What? My boy.
He's just trying to stay on top
of it. My boy.
He's no, quick.
We have tires 5 minutes away.
What? Yeah. Who does?
Chaos Divers.
Chaos Divers, you have tires.
We're not paying attention.
We're not paying attention. Jacob, call me right now. What are you talking about? All right.
For the love of God, answer it. Dave Mack, okay, Dave. What do you want me to answer? Okay, remember, now listen. Wait. Nick, oh, no. Oh, Nick says they still have a queen.
They do?
Yes. Right. Speaking of queen, can I tell them what happened to your YouTube channel one time?
Sure, go for it.
Okay.
I don't know. Yeah, let's be kind of vague-ish.
Vague-ish?
Vague-ish, but not too vague. Yeah, you go ahead.
Okay, so let's just say that Sam's YouTube channel.
Hold on. Oh my God. I didn't even think about this. I could FaceTime you.
Yeah, welcome.
No, quit giving him time. Right. He chose not to come on the show. Wait, I can't tell the story about you if you're going to be over there.
Hold on, they're talking.
Just hang up on Jacob.
I'll call you back.
Yeah, yeah.
Text me.
No, yeah. Listen to me. Oh. 5 minutes away, there's tires for you.
What do you mean?
Who's the person?
There's a person on there that keeps saying that there's 5 minutes away, there's tires for you.
Get their number and text it.
It's showing up about 1,600 it did. Times.
Why are you guys not paying attention?
What's the name?
I think Jacob's making it up.
Jacob's trying to tell you.
He's just trying to get airtime.
I'm trying to get airtime. I'm trying to get your tires.
Thanks.
Someone said tires are coming.
Tires are coming.
Tires are coming? We got tires on the way? That might be the 5 minute tires.
My heart just went pitter patter. Like, if we really have tires coming.
That's awesome, bro. Thank you.
Like.
No. 5 minutes away.
Also, thank you, Rebecca.
They might have tires for you, and they're only 5 minutes away. Read the chat.
Okay.
No, that's different, okay? What do you mean? We're not doing no emergency services, Jacob. That's going to cost 10 times more than if we just wait till morning. But no, we also have Colleen or whoever at 2 to 3 a.m.
Yeah.
So we have that.
I'll read the chats. Thanks.
Yeah. I'm sorry, because I'm on the phone that the live is happening, so I cannot take your phone call. You can text me, and I can read your text, but I cannot answer your phone call right now. So, Brandon, I'm sorry.
Thanks, Scott, for the donation.
And Rebecca.
Helping us out.
Scott Phillips, yes, thank you very much. And
thank you, Rebecca.
We have a Rebecca. Yes, you guys are awesome helping out these families. Thank you, Rebecca, for being on here.
Anyway, so back to your story, Jared, about how Sam had his channel removed.
Oh, yes, because we were talking about the queen. And the queen reminds me of another word. Okay, it's close to another word. Am I allowed to talk about this one?
Yeah.
Okay. So Sam had his channel hacked, and they changed his YouTube channel name.
Oh, yes.
Can I talk about this one?
Talk about it. Go for it.
Okay.
No shame in my game.
Okay. Are we allowed to say, like, who and why? Like, we actually don't know.
Yeah,
for sure.
Yeah, we don't know. We have very strong suspicions.
Yeah, we have strong suspicions as to who may have hacked his YouTube account. They deleted every single one of his videos and changed his name to, do you want to say it?
I'll say it. Queer Gin. So.
Yes. Yeah, so, and the queen reminded me, not because of queens, yes, so. We did end up changing his name back to
Sam the Adventure Sam, Man. Sam, I now have control of the channel. I'll start putting out more content. You guys stick around, check me out. There'll be lots of stuff there.
And if you're just coming on also, the content that Sam is kind of focusing on this trip, as we're shooting the regular Adventures with Purpose, Dan the cameraman, and he's editing it, Sam is kind of doing more of a behind-the-scenes story, more of an extended cut what we're doing in front of the camera. Not necessarily longer, just a different version of what's going on. So definitely check out, if you've already done so. Is it already changed to Sam the Adventure Man on YouTube?
Sam the Adventure Man.
Okay, and I have a link in some of my descriptions where Sam has been in the videos, where there's a link over to his YouTube channel.
Russell the Rhino, Stoppel.
Wait,
Thank you.
Alan wants to know where we are. We are stuck right now in Morris, Illinois. So if anybody is in Morris, Illinois and has some trailer tires for us, we need two new trailer tires. Not one, but two. because like I'm really surprised that we even made it. We broke down 9 miles down the road, and we happened to limp in to Walmart.
Yes.
4 minutes after they close, but come to find out, it sounds like they don't even have tires for us, so we're stuck here. And we need to be in Kokomo, Indiana, in the morning. We're 137 miles away from Kokomo, Indiana.
I'm almost there.
Because we're going over there to help Jerry, the grandmother of Karina, who supposedly has been killed by her drug dealer.
Wild.
To give him a hot shot. This has been, I don't even know how long it's been now, but I mean, there's some crazy stories behind this one also. If you're just now coming on and you've not gone back, let me tell you like our 2020 road trip. Should we go ahead and tell them again? I'll give them like the short version of it.
Yeah.
All right, so the short version is we're all on a road trip across the entire U.S. from Oregon. We stopped off in Colorado already. We got the snowcat.
That was awesome.
So snowcat video comes out tomorrow. Thanks to Dan editing over 20 hours. Then we went to Hampton, Iowa today. We drove 16 hours overnight to get to Hampton, Iowa. In Hampton, Iowa, we were looking for Ethan. So if anybody is up for a real treasure hunt, there is a $100,000 reward for Ethan if you can find him. The video that we did today in looking for him, we looked in...
Tires are on the way.
I like that. We looked in... thank you very much. We looked in 8 ponds, 1 creek... Is that what we did? 8 ponds and a creek?
Yes.
So 8 ponds and a creek today. We did not, so the video will show you exactly where Ethan is not, meaning you now have a greater chance of finding Ethan and claiming a $100,000 reward for helping.
We did some elimination work for you.
Yes, we did.
So there you go. Go get your money.
Yes. And we might even go back because Tony from Lake of the Ozarks did some additional detective work for us as well. And there's another body of water that he may have identified that we might need to swing back to as we're going back to Oregon.
Okay, that's cool.
Anyway.
And speaking of money, thank you, Christina C., for the donation.
Thank you, Christina.
Greatly appreciated.
Mm-hmm. So then we're going to, where are we going? After Kokomo, then we're going to Pennsylvania for 4 days. Yeah. And then, and that one's cars in a quarry. And you never know, there could be somebody in those. I didn't tell you about the cars in that quarry. In Pennsylvania that we're going to. One of them is a barracuda, uh-huh. I've been told, and one of them is a firebird.
All right, heck yeah.
I don't know what year they are, but I mean, barracudas are old.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
So we have that. And then we're going to Vermont for a homicide.
Chaos divers.
No, quit giving him airtime. Don't even say the word chaos, nor diver. We don't say that word anymore.
Oh, the moon looks super cool.
Oh, wait, unless he rolls in right now with two tires, we are not mentioning his name anymore. It shall be the name we knew not speak of because he had the opportunity to go on this road trip with us. Okay? He turned it down. Anyway, in all seriousness, Jacob is an incredible friend and supporter of everything we do. Jacob was actually on the Nathan video with us. He was participating. I know he really wanted to dive, but was he even a diver at that time?
No,
he was a new diver.
I think he had like 16 dives because I asked him, you remember?
Or maybe, was it like, six?
I don't know. I said, hey, bro, how many dives you got? He said like 10.
Yeah. And I was so like, has a lot more now. I think he's either a master diver now or he's really close. So
he has more certifications than I do.
He has more than I do. I mean, he's done an incredible job. Diving and learning and training,
yes,
and really pushing himself. So as much as I harass Jacob, we really do.
It's love.
It is love.
It's love.
It's brotherly love for sure. Anyway, Jacob is meeting up with us in Kentucky on possibly the semi-truck, the helicopter, also down in Nashville, Tennessee on the missing gentleman. So it's Christine's husband. Her and her family and some friends have reached out to us because he was just, after 38 years of working, too much pain in his hands, unemployment issues, as well as work said you can't come to work anymore. So sad case on that one, in that he just ended up leaving the house one morning without his shoes. He never went anywhere without his shoes. Said that he couldn't even drive more than like a mile because his feet hurt so bad. So they know that he didn't drive very far, and there's a boat ramp around the corner from his house that 3 cars have been identified in. So that's, I don't know what that means.
DKK, thank you.
Oh, DKK, thank you very much for your donation. It's a 50, I don't know what that actually means. So it's not a dollar amount. I don't know what that is. But whatever it is, we appreciate it. Thank you. In fact, tell me right now, what is a 50 in whatever that is? Anyway, so Christine's husband, Will.
I think
it's
Danish.
Danish? I don't know what that, okay.
Jared won't let me have any Danishes.
No, you're not allowed to have any Danishes.
No Danishes for me.
Oh, are they calling for help? I can hear them dialing a phone. I don't think they're calling for us.
So someone said, do we ever go to Washington State? Actually, we did a BMW in Washington State. I'm from Washington State, so yes, we go to Washington State.
And anybody that actually doesn't know Sam the Invention Man, like Sam is a 50-ton
Inland Master. And I,
boat captain. That's what that means. And Sam has, I'm going to say that Sam has, can I turn my phone this way and it's going to still work? Orientation locked, rotate device back, nope. Sam has the coolest job out of everybody, in my opinion. And that is, think about AAA, except on the water.
Yeah.
Sam has a rescue boat.
The rescue boat, yep.
Like, what was your busiest day this year as a rescue captain?
Man. I rescued like 9 boats. Probably 2 of them were actually in serious trouble.
Sinking,
for maybe a total of maybe like 43 people. You know, rescuing 43 people in a day, that's kind of wild.
No, it's incredible. Yeah.
The broke mofo, thanks for the $5. Now you're a little broker.
That's pretty. I want you to talk more about what it is you do. Like, what has been your wildest, this summer, what has been, do they know us?
I hope so.
What has been your wildest rescue this summer?
Oh man, the wildest one is I got a call. There's 6 people on a boat that was sinking and they were all scared and just petrified. And you know, if they hadn't called me and if I hadn't gotten there when I did, you know, they all would have been swimming, you know, just getting there, you know, throwing the pumps in their boat, pumping out all the water, you know, just securing everything, making sure that they were good. And there was panic, you know, so it was just, you know, you just jump in that. And then after you're done, you know, and you get them to safety and you just start driving away, it just kind of hits you, you know, it's like what you actually did, you know, that you really made a difference in somebody's day. It's just super, super humbling. You know, most of the time it's people that ran out of gas or maybe they left their lights on and it drained their battery. But every now and then, you know, people are sinking, people ran aground, there's boats that are on fire, people, you know, are drifting off, people are just in real bad situations, you know. And so when you go and you actually, you know, save people, I mean, that really hits, you know. Just, I love it. I love it to pieces. Just one of those things that feels good, and you know, I get to go home and tell my kids about it, and you know, kids think I'm cool, so that's all I really care about.
Somebody wants to know, how do you call for a rescue on a boat? I'm going to answer this one. First of all, step one, you have to be on a boat.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
Step two.
Yeah. So you just call. You know, a lot of people they Google, or there's also a thing called Towboat US. It's like AAA but for the water. So you pay for a membership, it's like $170 and it covers you for a whole year. And so you call them just like on AAA and they call me and then I come high speed, come save you. You know, just that simple. Or if you don't have the membership, you just Google it, you call tow boats, rescue boats, you call the Coast Guard. In fact, a lot of times you call the Coast Guard and they'll direct you to us because our boats are much faster and it's one person per boat. We can do everything. Where the Coast Guard boats, usually it's 6 or 7 people. But our boats, you know, just one-man team, you know, we're out there whooping butt, you know, just doing what needs to be done.
So. Yeah. Somebody did ask me, Nautica, I think, asked me about Abigail. Abigail has been found, and the story with Abigail, it's really, if you guys watch the Abigail story, at the very end of it, you will have noticed that we almost didn't put that video out, but as I was talking to, her aunt, it was like, you know what? We are going to put this story out because we need to spread the word about Abigail missing. We need people down at the river. And so what ended up happening on that one is that one of our viewers were watching it, told her husband about it, knowing that he knows that river well, and said, you need to go down there and check out the river. So instead of him going fishing at his regular fishing spot that day, he went down to the river on a hunch as to where Abigail might be. And he is the one that actually is the one that found Abigail because of us actually going live with that story.
Yeah, wow, that's wild.
So,
Christina Gonzalez, thank you. Thanks for the 20. I appreciate the sub.
Thank you. A little trucker girl as well.
Who do we have? Christina. Yes, thank you very much. And
Little Trucker Girl.
Little Trucker Girl. Hi from Alberta, Canada. I love watching you help families and find their loved ones.
People are saying we should make coins out of the old...
I think that this is still, though, not aluminum. Speaking of coins, okay, Jacob Grubbs, can you put up a... I didn't even realize that you were actually in here helping us, like, as a moderator. Do you know that? You're not even a moderator
No,
in here.
No, I'm not. That's, I'm okay.
Yeah, yeah. See, this is...
I don't need to be.
This is why I can't actually make fun of Jacob. So, again, we gave him a big shout-out. Jacob,
he'll delete us.
Yeah. Yes. Jacob, put in MrLysik.com/coins. We have some new coins that are coming out because Dan is working on a new CNC machine that we got, a little desktop. It's kind of like a $400 cheap one, but we're doing graphite molds instead of sand casting, and we're going to try to make better coins. So I still have enough coins made. 130 coins of the RX-7 coins have shipped out.
137?
130 of them, of the RX-7 coins. I have told everybody that we will not do any more than 100 or 250, so I can still make 120 more of the RX-7 coins, and I have enough aluminum from the RX-7 for that one. So we're going to make it with the new graphite molds is what we're going to do.
Nice, nice.
In addition to that, we have the BMW, so I think we're going to try to make 500 coins with the BMW. A lot of aluminum was on there.
Yeah.
We may even get 1,000 coins on that one. Can you post the website? Jacob, please post the website. It's MrLysik.com/coins is for the to get on the mailing list. So that way when the coins do come out, you'll be notified right away about that.
Car guy, Hillsboro, Oregon. I used to live in Forest Grove. A lot of family in Hillsboro. Yeah. How's it going, man?
Yeah. So coming back to this wheel, I think this is a steel one, though. Is this aluminum or is it steel? Oh, you know what? I have a magnet. We can test
All right, just test it.
Yeah.
Might as well.
All right, keep reading me. What does your wife think of you doing this on bringing cars up and closure for people? She's scared to death for me.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the reality of it. Here's the thing. I have another YouTube channel back in, you know, my original stuff. Like when I first got into, when GoPro first came out, I was
paramotor stuff.
Paramotor stuff.
I love watching that.
Power paraglider. So youtube.com/Lysik. And you're going to see like all of my stuff when I worked, I used to work for reality TV shows, shooting aerial footage, my personal stuff, flying over mountains, putting my foot in rivers. I've been in lakes and stuff, but I crashed a lot.
It was sparking, so it's steel. That's what we're, that's so far, that's the vote.
Well, that's how we do it? Yep. Well, let's throw a magnet on there. Just I can agree with that. So I used to do power paragliding. And when I actually started the YouTube, it was actually a power paragliding show to begin with. But nobody wanted to watch that.
I like watching it.
Okay. So, thank you. And so I got into, and my dive gear had actually, I got into diving back in 2006 with my father and my brother. My wife was supposed to do it. But when she first saw the training video, the before you even get any training for diving, you watch these videos. And in one of them, it was a, do you remember the balloon? Where you,
explodes.
Yeah, where the balloon explodes. Yeah. So basically it's a representation. Yeah, it represents your lungs, and if you hold your breath and you come up, the balloon blew up, which represented your lungs, and you will die. And because of that, my wife decided not to do it, and so that's how my brother ended up scuba diving with us. And so that happened in 2006. Well, for 10 years, just life got busy. You know, my kids are still growing up. I was raising them, and I didn't do any diving. And it wasn't until 2 years ago that I pulled all my dive gear off again to become a YouTube scuba diver. And that's kind of how I got... Oh, so anyways, to answer your question, how does she feel about all of this? One, she's very supportive of Sam and I and Dan being on the road. She knows that, you know, that... Do we call this my midlife crisis? Kind of, sort of. Is that my...
Oh, this is a pretty cool crisis.
Yes, is that my children are now growing. My youngest is now 20. And so I now have the opportunity to, when it's time to be a dad and to be a husband at home, I'm doing that, but also to come out, I don't know what my purpose is in life. I honestly don't. But I know that it gives, that Sam and I, we've really become addicted, really.
Oh yeah, it feels great.
To the ability to come out here to serve, to help families that they don't,
yeah,
they just don't have this before.
Yeah.
and the families that we've already helped, whether it was on purpose or on accident, but also those that we're coming out here for right now. In fact, even just tonight, like I got a message from somebody that's gonna be in Kokomo with us. This, I'm holding the weight because I was gonna see if it's metal or not, that just said that this is, you guys are doing more for this family than anybody else has done for this family. We're talking about Karina for tomorrow that we're going to take a look at. So because of that, my wife is very amazing. She's very supportive. We just celebrated 25 years as well. Honey, if you're on here, give me a text if you're on here. My wife doesn't actually watch all my stuff. So I don't. Anyway, we're going to see if that's metal or not. Oh, yeah. See, that's steel. Oh. Yeah, so that's not aluminum. Because magnets will not stick to aluminum. So that answers that question. All right, back to comments because I haven't been looking at it.
Recap on tire situation, please.
Yes, recap on tire situation. We need two tires. So if anybody is, oh wait, no, we heard that we have tires coming. But anyway, I'll give you the, oh, Kiara says that they're watching.
Ben Roethlisberger.
Wait, before we get to Ben, I gotta say hello to my wife and my girls. Kiara, Kiki the camera girl is watching me. The thumb is up. You can't see that right now. Or she waves, or thumbs down sometimes.
Yeah.
Amazing. Kiara, I miss having you on the show. You really should have come. I would have kicked Dan out, so that way you could have had the bed in there with Sam and I. It would have been amazing. However, she says that she doesn't like hanging out with a couple of old dudes.
Old dudes.
Yeah, so yeah, anyway, so Kiki, the camera girl's on watching. Malia, my other daughter, and my wife, they're all watching. So thank you, girls. Love you to death. We're out here having a blast, but when I come back, like, it'll be Halloween is when I'm back, and then we have the holiday season and everything, so we're gonna go have a good time, and I promise I'm gonna take all of December off. But the good news is we will have shot enough content. Dan's gonna be busy making videos for us.
Yep.
All right, back to Todd. What do we need to say about Todd?
I don't remember.
I thought we were on the
wheels. I remember.
Oh, we're answering the question, bringing people up to speed about the tires. Yeah. So what ended up happening last night, I got out of the gas station at midnight, 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock in the morning. It was really late, was what it was. I don't remember when it was.
What'd you say? What time?
I don't know, like 2 in the morning?
When we
changed the first tire.
Oh yeah, it was late.
Yeah. And I realized this tire was actually on the other side. And so it was bald right here, and it's only bald right here, which was really weird, but it also has like a big slit in the tire. And so I ended up taking that one off. I'm like, that tire's gonna blow in like the next 100 miles. So I said, that tire's off. We had a spare tire that was right here. And so that spare tire ended up being placed right here. And it's actually a fairly good tire. We had to air it up a little bit, but that tire's, fairly decent. Anyway, in fact, see, look, I bought this at a yard sale for like 25 bucks. See, it said keep. Anyway, so then this tire over here this evening, Sam is cruising down the road. Sparks start flying.
We got a phone number we're calling.
Of somebody that's coming?
Maybe, with
some tires? So then that tire ended up blowing. This whole metal thing, all this rubber, you couldn't even see the rubber. It was actually stuck behind the wheel, and the trailer was sitting on the ground. So it was like hard enough just to get, trailer up to begin with. But anyway, we got that tire off. But now then we had to put the tire we took off last night that we're scared to drive. Luckily, we were only 9 miles down the road from Morris, Illinois is where we're stuck. We got here to Walmart, come to find out because of COVID, their tire center is closed. But we also got here like 3 minutes after the entire store closed because some Walmarts actually sell tires and wheels at Walmarts, like mine does. This one evidently is all out of tires. There's an emergency tire service here, but that would be like 10 times more expensive.
Yeah, that'd be cutting into the shoestring budget.
Yeah, we're like shoestringing this to begin with. And
shoestring all volunteers.
And so where we're at is we're stuck in Morris, Illinois right now. If anybody, wait, we have tires coming though.
We haven't seen them yet.
Yeah, we haven't seen any tires.
We haven't seen them.
So supposedly at 2 or 3 o'clock this morning, we're supposed to have somebody that might come, a viewer that was on here. Were they working or what was going on? Colleen? Colette?
40 minutes away.
40 minutes away?
Yeah, no idea.
And then we had another one that said they were 5 minutes away?
I don't know. The one 5 minutes away.
No, 5 minutes away. So we're waiting on tires, because if we can get tires tonight, we can keep rolling to Kokomo, Indiana.
We'll make our appointment on time.
Make our appointment tomorrow, because the family has been waiting for somebody to come help them. They've reached out. Some other viewers have reached out to tell us about Karina, who, 18-year-old, who ended up going missing, because the rumor is that she was given a hot shot. A hot shot is a lethal dose of drugs in order to take care of, you know.
Yep.
And so it's a sad story. And the reason why is the rumor, I think, is this, that she stole from her drug dealer, is what I've been told. Listen, I made some bad choices in life. I never made any bad drug choices, but I made a lot of bad choices in life. And my wife, thank you very much, honey, I often tell her, and it's probably 100% true, Dan, is that I would probably be in prison had I not married my wife. True story. Probably is. My kids have kept me, being a dad for me has been incredible, because it's, it gave me purpose in life to be a good person, to be a better person. And it's really turned me into, you know, who I am today. And so, thank you. Thank you for that, girls. What else do I want to say? What do you want to say, Dan?
Don't know. Overwhelmed by the comments.
Yeah?
Everyone is.
Where did they break down at? We are in Morris, Illinois. Broke down right now. What is your favorite piece of equipment? What would I say? I'm going to say the, as far as camera wise, like, I really enjoy the art of storytelling, to bring you into the world of sharing something with you that you would not normally get the opportunity to see. So for me, that equipment, I really enjoy from the air.
Andrew Halverson says he's two blocks away with two tires. Andrew.
Are you serious?
Yeah, right here. That's what somebody says. Andrew Halverson says he's two blocks away with two tires. Come see us, man.
Please, please do.
Please, please.
Yes. What was I talking about, Dan?
Something really important, I'm sure.
Storytelling.
It's the art of storytelling.
The art of storytelling. So that's my favorite equipment, is the ability that you guys listen to me. And the stories that I tell and that I bring you into, and the opportunities to clean up the environment and the opportunities to help families. Aside from that, then I guess it would come to like dive gear. Like, what would be my favorite piece of equipment for dive gear? It's all, I love it all.
I kind of like the boat.
The boat has been really good.
Yeah.
So we've really used the boat a lot.
How about your spare air? He just recently got a spare air, or a pony bottle.
A pony bottle.
Yeah, why don't you tell him about your pony bottle.
In fact, I talk about the pony bottle in tomorrow's episode with the Snowcat, which, by the way, I still have to upload the video, and it's 10 gigabytes, Dan. Thank you for that. The pony bottle is amazing, because now I have safety backup, whereas before I had the single tank on my back. And if anything happened to that tank, it would kill both my regulator as well as my secondary air source that's on my BC, because it's hooked to the one main tank. And so with the new pony bottle, it's a separate system that I have hooked to my BC, and it's hooked to my secondary air. And so should anything happen to my main tank, like the first stage goes out, or I run out of air, like when we were in Missouri, because of the force of the river.
Yeah, I was pushing on
you. Yeah. I now have that pony bottle where I'm not gonna be out of air, where I could potentially die. Yes, which is one of those things that my wife was really worried about.
Yeah.
So
keep the happy wife.
Yes. So anyway, because of the pony bottle, my diving is,
Sam, check your Facebook messages.
Like 7.
I will check my Facebook messages.
You better. It might be a tire coming to us.
I hope so. Annie P., thank you. Thanks for the donation.
So I hope that answered your question on that one, for the pony bottles.
I gotta put my app back on. I totally deleted everything. So.
Yeah. Oh, somebody said that Walmart has Wi-Fi?
Wi-Fi?
Yeah, Gravity 461. I didn't know that they had that. Oh, wait a minute. Did we say thank you to Heather Baxter?
I don't know.
She's $19.99, says you are amazing.
Thank you.
Yeah, she's talking to you, Sam.
I think she's talking to everyone.
She's talking to Dan. Thank you very much. And then we also ended up with $10 from Annie P. Good luck. You guys are the best. Thank you very much. You know, with this evening's donation, is that our tires?
I don't know. That's the same.
I think that's the same.
That's the same car.
Same car, though.
Yeah. I don't know if they were honking that. I don't think so, because they're going to the right.
If you're watching, you should come over and say hello.
Yeah, if you're in Morris, Illinois, we're going to be here for at least...
Yeah, we'll be here for a little while.
Yeah, yes. Are you RV neighbors able to sleep? Oh, I didn't even think about the RV neighbors over there.
Maybe you should go on the other side.
Sorry, RV neighbors. I know, we didn't think about them. Illinois has no S's, it's silent. Really?
Thank you.
Wait a minute. So how do you say Illinois? Illinois?
Yeah, I think so.
Really?
Yeah.
Listen. If you've not seen my stuff already, you know that for me, it's a Jaguar, okay?
Jaguar.
It's not a Jaguar.
Jaguar.
It's a Jaguar.
I agree with you.
Listen, I grew up in Sam Pete County, Utah. Right, Brandon Larson? I know he's on here. Sam Pete County, Utah. We say crick instead of creek. Booger instead of like burger. We say burger.
Booger.
Booger. You want a burger?
Burger.
Uh-huh. All right, I'm reading comments again.
Okay.
So they just, hold on, let me scroll up a little bit so I can catch a few. Where in PA will you be? I don't know, what's the one on the far right side of the state? We're gonna be in Quakertown, north of Pottsville is where we're gonna be.
To
what part of Georgia? Lake Altoona is where we're going. Is that how you say it? So that's where we're gonna be. And then Patrick says the S is silent. Washington.
Okay, so I just checked my messages here. Says there's a TA truck stop that sells tires 24/7.
Yeah, those are truck tires, and they're going to be expensive.
Yeah, it's a little pricey. We're kind of on a shoestring budget.
And here's the other thing, too. We can't just go with a tire. We have to have a whole new wheel, because Sam ruined the entire wheel.
Yep.
So if anybody is in the Morris, Illinois area that can help us out with not just tires, but two tire wheel setups, we can't go with just one tonight. Like, we actually need two to hit the road.
Yes.
All right, let me scroll back down.
So maybe that's what they meant by the 5 minutes away was that TA.
Like the TA?
Yeah.
That's a bummer. I was more excited. Like, I had butterflies for a little bit. What else we got? What dive certifications do you have? Trevor wants to know. Trevor, here's the thing.
I have the same one you do.
Same one as you.
It's the same one.
Yes.
One.
No, actually, I have two.
You got more than me.
I have one. I end up with the dry suit certification. So anyway, in order to become certified, there's a couple different organizations out there. There's PADI. Mm-hmm. There's SSI.
NAWI.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So there's NAWI as well. And in order for you to get any air fills for your air, you have to be certified under one of those.
Or you can't get air.
Or you can't get air.
Got to go diving without it.
Yeah. Yeah, just long hose.
Yep.
So I am open water certified. You're open water certified. And that is it. And what that means is that we can dive to 60 feet.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it.
That's it. And if we go any further, the scuba police will come and get us.
You know, I've been avoiding them for years. So luckily, there are no actual scuba police. And so really, it comes down to the, like anything. You know, a school of hard knocks, you really don't want school of hard knocks in this, so you don't want to mess up.
No. You definitely want to go with people more experienced with you, or than you, just like I did.
Yeah.
I remember starting out diving, I'd be huddled right in between two people because I was afraid some kind of shark would come and snatch me. You know, so I'm really grateful to the people who kind of brought me under their wing and showed me the ropes and, you know, just let me do stupid things and keep me safe. So, thanks, guys.
Yeah. And I also let people come out and do stupid things with me. So... Which is, I don't consider it stupid. We have a lot of good time. Richard McNew, hello from Utah. You guys are the best. Thank you very much. We also have polos, $5, couple bucks for some coffee on the road. Just stumbled on y'all the other day and love what you're doing. Keep it up. Thank you very much. We will definitely keep it up. Let me scroll back up. Dave Mack. Dave, I don't even know what you're saying. He just says, even me. So,
even me.
Dave, I am not reading.
Erica says hi. Erica, I'm not. She says hi.
Hey, Erica, how you doing?
Right,
Erica has actually been out with us.
Yeah.
She was there when we found Tim Robinson.
Yes, she was there, and her and I, we split a pizza. She was cool.
That is right, yes. Let me scroll back up a little bit here. So, TA has RV tires? Will you call over there and see if they have wheels and tires?
I'll call.
Okay.
TA.
Because, in fact, I can see them.
Truck stop.
Yeah, they're just right across the way.
All right.
And we can actually make it over there.
0.4 miles away. We're walking distance.
Yeah, well, we'll drive over there. We can still drive. When are you going to be in Pennsylvania? I'm going to be in Pennsylvania on the, I'm rolling in the night of the 26th, and we're going to be diving the 27th, 28th, 29th, up in Quakertown. So if you're anywhere near there, you're welcome to come hang out at a quarry, supposed to have 10 to 15 cars. And then we have the ROV training, the underwater drone training,
hey,
on the 30th. Really excited about that. What else do we want to talk about? Comment lag.
Okay, sweet.
Yeah, find out how much they are. Do they have them?
I'm getting transferred to a shop right now.
Oh, okay.
Do you want to hear or no?
Yeah. TA won't have car tires, but they do have trailer and RV tires and roadside service. Call them.
All right, we're calling.
Okay.
Thanks for the donation, little trucker girl.
She did again?
Again?
Thank you.
Do you need a Reed Harley's Adventure Corners comment?
Reed Harley's Adventures Corners comment, please.
I'll try and
I don't know what that means.
So, someone with that name commented.
Can you please
hold?
Yes.
All right, let me scroll back up. Some of these can message Jared to link up. Please check when you get a chance. Okay, I'll check it out, Jonah. When do you plan on coming to North Carolina? What are the dates on North Carolina? Do you know?
North Clackalacky.
Nope.
Let me go look. I'll just go take a look right now. Talk about Lake of the Ozarks again. Tony is messaging me privately to talk about the. Like, what do you want to say about that, Tony? We have a boat that's 60 feet deep. Is this what you want me to talk about? I'm not reading comments now, so I hope this is what you want me to talk about, Tony. We have a boat that's 60 feet deep in Lake of the Ozarks that might have 4 or 5 people who have passed away 3 years ago on it. With that, I'm checking the dates for North Carolina here, by the way. So 4 people passed away on it, no next of kin, no insurance, and the state, I believe it was a state patrol, said do not touch that boat. It was what they told my friend, I think that the reason why is we're just dealing with a government agency who doesn't have the resources or the money to pull this boat, because it would be like a $30,000-$50,000 recovery on it. And so I think that we're going to go ahead and just go ahead and do it. North Carolina, let me tell you.
Ooh, we do. What size are we looking for, Jared?
Well, you got to go back out and take a look. It was like a 255 something. It's a five lug. I'm going to be in North Carolina. Let me tell you. Where is North Carolina? October 4th, 5th, and 6th. We're doing 3 to 4 videos. We have 6 vehicles that are there with a missing 17-year-old teen. The teen's name is Nicholas. He took his mom's car. I think that he recently broke up with his girlfriend, but I don't quote me on that one. And he has, he ended up stealing a .22 rifle as well.
Okay, thank you so much.
And the rumors that he may have taken the rifle in order to sell for gas money to get to Springfield, Illinois, because he has family members up there as well. However, as far as they know, he never made it to Springfield, Illinois. And there's 6 cars that have been identified in the river, not too far from where his house is at in Yadkin. I think that's how you say it. Yadkin, North Carolina. Not too far from Linwood is where that one is at.
Yeah, so the just called there, and actually they do not have any tires or any rims.
All right, so.
And then in fact, it sounded like a viewer called. So thank you to the viewer that called to check for us.
Yep.
We appreciate you.
Hold on. I'm hoping the more you talk about the boat, the less the government will care. I really don't want to go to jail over it. LOL.
Who said that?
Tony. Tony.
Oh, Tony? Ozark,
yeah.
Tony?
Yeah, he wants me to talk more about it. Tony doesn't want to go to jail. So that's why Tony would like us to do it, because we are not associated with any government agency. We don't have the red tape. We are citizens that are out there diving, doing a good thing. And so because we have you, the amazing viewers, supporting us, honey, if you're still on, don't be worried that I might go to jail. I don't.
Speaking of honey.
Wait, just make sure that she knows I'm going to tell her. Yeah. We're not really going to jail.
No, we're not going to jail. We're taking care of, you know,
we could go to jail.
Well,
she's going to call me later.
Well, I think I might be able to run faster than Jared. I don't know. Actually, he's lost some weight.
Yeah, though, I can
be able to outrun me.
Speaking of honeys, are we going to mention?
Yeah, Xander and Renee, how's it going? My girlfriend and her son are watching, so, hey guys.
Wait, I thought we were going to pitch you a single on this trip.
Yeah, right.
Just kidding, Renee. No, Sam is actually taken, so I'm sorry, ladies. Yep. Sam is taken, and yeah, and Dan the cameraman is also taken.
Also taken. So yep. We are.
So just a couple of.
Yeah, just a couple just of lockdown a, dudes.
Yep.
We're on lockdown.
Hanging out in the RV. So, all right, next up to the, hi, I love your videos. Thank you very much. Heather Baxter, thank you very much. So we have Kara Alvarez. Love you guys. Love all you do. Man. Thank you very much. For $4.99 and Heather Baxter.
Do you guys see this? Do you guys see this?
He's eating pizza in front of you.
Do you know how good this smells? Jared has me on a super shred weight loss program. Yes. Where I'm eating like oatmeal and berries. Uh-huh. And Dan's sitting here, he's eating a cold pizza and it just smells so delicious. I could like from 5 feet away I could smell it. I mean, just it looks delicious.
I see the way that you're looking at that pizza too. Like,
I'm gonna salivate, yeah, man.
Like you're just about ready to like tear that from him. Like you
said. Oh my gosh. That's
don't
fantastic.
Eat it. I forgot
what's
to tell
it, what's
you.
It, what's it taste like?
Yeah.
Pizza.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
All right. Let me scroll back on these comments over here.
Low and Steadies keeps asking, when is the next time you will be in the Deschutes?
In the Deschutes River? I probably will never be in the Deschutes again, to be honest with you. And the reason for it is Loot the Deschutes.
Loot the Deschutes. Sounds cool.
They have an Instagram. And they came in and started doing, they're free divers. So they're not, they do some diving, but they're more free divers because the river is actually not that deep. And so they kind of took over where I had left when I started doing cars.
Oh, that's awesome.
They stepped in, they started doing Loot the Deschutes. And
and
they are incredible at what they do. Like, I mean, you thought that I did some good stuff there? No, like they find stuff like I couldn't even find stuff before. So. Like when I went out to find stuff for somebody, I couldn't find it. And then they went in like the next day and they found it. And I felt kind of bad. Anyway, so incredible. Kiara says, my daughter Kiki, the camera girl, says pizza party. It's only a pizza party for Dan.
Pizza party for one.
Uh-huh. And he's like, and Dan's like, ain't no party like a pizza party.
Because a pizza party don't stop. Except for us. Yeah, the pizza party has stopped.
Yeah, there's no carbs for you. There's no bread. I'm going to say there's carbs, but there's no breads for you.
No bread. I'm thinking about eating some dry oatmeal.
Yeah.
I'm hungry.
Well, you can have some milk with it.
Some milk?
Yeah, you can.
Like real, like milk? Like,
no, not real milk. Just oat milk or almond milk.
I do like almond milk.
Yeah. So. Where and when are you coming to Kentucky? We're going to Cumberland, Kentucky, and that's going to be after North Carolina. When did I say North Carolina was? I think it was the 4th, 5th, and 6th.
Yeah.
And then I think we're going to Lake Cumberland right after that. So the 7th and 8th ish, somewhere around there. Yeah. So somewhere around there.
Yeah, we have friends in that area.
Yep. Let's see what else we got. Yes, so Frank up in Washington private messaged me. He said flats suck. Yes, yeah. They do.
especially when they're sparking.
Yes.
Sparkly flats.
Wait, that was really cute the way that you did
like that.
Yeah, that was cute.
Little sparkle there.
Yeah.
We got another donation from Russell the Rhino Stopple.
Hey, have Sam check Facebook Market. Also need details on the weight loss. Disabled veteran need to drop weight. In my most recent videos, reach out, check out Arc Revolution. I have a personal trainer who will help set up a personalized training program for you. And then if you don't want to do like the whole personal training portion of it, we also have, I actually recorded over 100 days of my personal workouts with Dennis as I went through this and lost the weight. So that's available to you as well. But you do have to check out Arc Revolution, talk to Dennis, and he'll be able to help set you up on that one. All right, so that's the answer for you on that one. Russell the Rhino Stopple. Stopple? All right, let me try to scan.
Jacob, let's not encourage that.
Jacob better not be taking advantage of what he's doing. What did he do?
Oh, I'm just giving him a hard time.
Okay. Okay, nice meeting you. You should go to Cumberland Falls while you're there. Is Cumberland Falls at Lake Cumberland? We're going to be at Lake Cumberland. Stop eating equals lose weight. See, just that simple. Okay? So Camping Mods told you that. Just stop eating and you will lose plenty of weight. Hey, AWP from North Carolina. Hey, we'll be there soon. Soy milk is also nice. Any plans to come to Michigan? Not at the moment. No plans for Michigan. There are some stuff that we have up there that we know of. You think about getting more diving certifications? No, I don't think about getting any more diving certifications at this time.
But definitely gaining skills and practicing and developing our diving abilities.
I got my open water. What is the bolt pattern to match? It's a five lug, Frank, but I don't know what the actual pattern is. I mean, it's a utility trailer. We don't know enough to know what the actual...
Yeah, we don't know about this stuff.
Yeah. So no idea on that one. So the lug pattern is five. That's what we have right there. This wheel is completely shot, so we need a new wheel. That tire is completely shot, so we need a new wheel and tire. Yeah, we're stuck right now.
Man, somebody's watching us from Israel.
Israel.
Wow, that's awesome.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, Dan.
Stop by Spokane, Cumberland Falls near Corbin. No, it's up the East River. Any updates on the missing bridesmaid story? There's kind of an update on the missing bridesmaid story. One is I feel like we've covered all of the water in that area. Mm-hmm. But all the water is my thing, Sam.
Yeah.
We have had a owner of a concrete company that does high rises in Portland. And he has a company south of there, about an hour, that says we have GPR equipment, ground penetrating radar equipment, who has reached out to me. But then all the fires started in Oregon. So because of all the fires that started in Oregon, we weren't able to actually get together. And so when I get back in November, I'll see if I can get together with Reed, who has the concrete company, who has the GPR. And we're gonna go out there and actually do ground penetrating radar along the road to see if by chance the truck got buried when they raised the levee.
Oh, wow.
Also the location where she might actually be at the reservoir heading up where her ex-husband may have buried her. And the ex-husband, by the way, has, as far as I understand, has passed away, as well as the other gentleman who may have known what happened to her. So we're still working on that one. We're working on the Martin family as well. So Scott and I will be working on that one again in November as well. So. Use dry suits instead of wetsuits. All right, so yeah, let me answer that one. So we have Colton95 Gaming asks, is there a reason why you all use dry suits instead of wetsuits? 100%, I'll tell you. I don't like getting wet.
No.
I mean, that's it.
No.
But in addition to that, we can actually put thermals on underneath.
Keep us warm.
And keep us warm.
Warm and dry. What
yes.
concept.
Yep. Whereas a wetsuit, so a wetsuit will let the water in, and it's like because it's up against your skin, it creates like a little insulation and like warmth. It warms up the water between the wetsuit and you, and that's kind of how wetsuits work. And they make different thicknesses, and the thicker it is, and the more weight you have to put on to sink. But anybody that dives in a wetsuit always complains about being cold.
Oh, absolutely.
All the time.
And Heather Baxter, fist bump. Thanks for the donation.
Thank you, Heather. So because we're in dry suits, I can wear gloves. I can wear gloves under my gloves. I can wear as many layers as I want. And I've dove in 34 degree weather, or 33 mm-hmm. water, 34. My mouth was a little cold.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
But my body itself was nice and warm.
Yeah.
The only time it doesn't is when your dry suit gets a leak and now you're wet inside.
Which happens from time to time.
Yep. All right. Somebody's telling me the most common five lug trailer lug pattern is a 5x4.5. I don't know what that means.
Yeah, I don't either. I'm going to go get some oatmeal. I'll be right back.
I need a sweater.
Yeah, I'll get you
a sweater. Here, I'll come inside.
Yeah, let's get it. Come on, guys.
Yeah, we can go inside.
We're going to get some oatmeal. You guys want some oatmeal?
Yeah.
That's all we're allowed to have, apparently.
Well, you really shouldn't be eating that either this late at night, but I'm going to go ahead and let you. The wheels on Jared's trailer is a 5x4.5. See, thank you, Chris. Chris, by the way, I got to tell you, why are you getting your oatmeal? I need a sweater. Yeah. But hey, wait, before you go, I'd like to also talk about your little experience with backing up my trailer and ruining my bumper and pushing it into the back of the RV.
That's true. That was me. I am new to backing up trailers. So Jared is going to teach me. By the end of the trip, I'll be a pro.
But so. I do have to also say that I can't blame you completely, because a few weeks before that, somebody did the same on the right-hand side.
Well, at least I didn't back into a house.
Listen, but in addition to that, look, he did an even worse job, and he buckled it up here. And on the trailer up down here, yeah, look, he did that as well. At least on your side, for where you did it, I don't think that you you didn't destroy
who
the trailer.
Did this one? Who'd you say did that one?
Yep.
Who was over here?
Oh, I did that one.
Oh, you did that one?
Yeah.
You put a hole?
Yeah, I did that.
So Jared put a hole. He's actually backed into his house. In fact, it's on video.
Oh, look, somebody just told me. Oh, Dan said 5 lugs, 4.5 inches apart. Okay. And a Ford Ranger and Jeep Cherokee rims will fit it as well. So if you can find a Ford Ranger and Jeep Cherokee rims, I feel like you're not trying to find them. All right. The wheel is a Ford lug pattern, 5x4.5, also known as a 5x114.3. Those wheels on the particular trailer are 5x4, have the smaller bolt pattern, and you can get them at Walmart. The Worley, except for the Walmarts right now, because of COVID, are actually pretty much out of tires, and you gotta wait 2 days for them to be delivered. Hey, where's the keys to the side? I'm gonna go measure these. All right, I'm gonna go do this. Dan, follow me. Well, hold on, wait. I need a sweater.
Check it out, I got my oatmeal, guys. It's my midnight snack.
Yeah. You cannot have berries any fruit this late at night.
All the nuts and the almonds?
Yes, you can put up to eight.
Well, I'm gonna take all eight then.
Okay, take all eight. So go ahead and eat that. I'm looking for a jacket. And then I'm gonna go measure what the bolt pattern actually is. Dan, I'm not reading comments at the moment, so if you can shout those out to me.
I'm too busy counting almonds to watch the comments. That's 8. Look at that. Perfect pour. 8.
All right. 100% Ford Ranger and Jeep Wrangler Cherokee wheels will fit. All right, so we need to go find a Ford Ranger or a Cherokee in the parking lot, is what Chris says, and we just need to jack it up and take their wheels.
Sounds like a plan.
Uh-huh. How about Toyota? Will those fit on it? We could take those ones. I wonder if they're still awake. All right, so in here. All right, any more questions that I can answer for anybody? Shout out some questions. Dan's reading comments, so shout out the questions, and I will answer them for you, or Dan will answer them for you. There was. All right, what I'm looking for is, I don't know if I have a tape measure or not.
Here we have a question. Do you have...
I don't know what's actually on my dry suit. O3 has taken incredible care of me. And so I don't know if it's Kevlar or if it's just extra padding or what it is. Look at that, I actually have a tape measure.
Okay, now we have a person asking, how do you get the milk from almonds?
Oh, you milk them, of course. I love that video. If you guys have not seen that video, definitely go milk the almonds. Somebody did a... Fiona, love your work, Jared. Been watching all your videos. Keep up the work and stay safe from Australia. Thank you very much, Fiona. And speaking of Australia, my wife and I and the girls were actually supposed to go down there with Down Under Dan diving. Huh. We were supposed to actually, instead of this trip, we were actually supposed to be down there for 6 weeks. I think it was 6 weeks we were supposed to go. But because of this whole COVID thing and your country being locked down, even with international or interstate travel, as I understand it, that killed our entire trip to go down there, because there's 7 cars down there that we know of and a few more that we've have reports on. So anyway, let's answer everybody's question as to exactly what size this is. So let me see if I can jump back over here. All right, so how do we measure this? Do we measure from like straight across like this? No, I don't think that's how we do it. Do we go like from here to here?
Thank you, Big Daisy, for the donation. They said it's a donation to pay for trailer backup training.
For both Sam and I. We both, actually, I do pretty good backing it up. It was just a really tight spot. I don't know how to measure this. So.
One guy says hold a hole.
Hold a hole? Like if I go this way?
Chaos Diver says hold a hole.
Like, do we go from, you're creating a shadow. All right, hold on. Do we go from there to there? And do we do from center to center?
Center to center.
Yeah, but do we go this way? From that one to that one?
No, I'd assume you.
Or do we go this way? Center to center, that's like 4.5 there. So that one kind of makes sense to me. Am I doing it right here? Do I go here? Tell Jared to stop. What do you mean, stop right here? Those are 5x4. How do you know they're 5x4? Because center to center is 4.5 there. Am I doing it the right way? Yes, across the rim, not around. Okay, move, quit putting shadows there, Sam. Hold on. Call local. Okay, so yes, they're saying that I'm doing it right now. And so that's 4.5. Is that correct? 5 holes by 4.5 inches across. All right, so we are confirmed that I'm doing it right, and it's 4.5. Yes, yes, yes. Look at that. We learned something new tonight.
We learned a lot of things tonight.
Yep. Dan, I know that Dan Mohanen, I'm sorry, I don't know how to say your last name. Dan is he works for the FAA, an incredible diver. He's been with me on a couple of videos. He's sending me text messages, and Dan, I can't read your messages if you have a picture. I can just quickly see because I'm actually live on my phone right now, so I apologize. So don't send me pictures. Sorry, not right now. Okay, could you next to you an extra hand? And a 4x4 in PA? Yes! Experado.
Let me see.
How do you say that? Experado.
Experado.
Yes.
Experado.
Could you use extra hands and a 4x4 in PA? Yes, especially if you have a winch and you're willing to help us pull things out. Yes, yeah, 100%. Awesome. Send me a message on Mr. Lysak. We're going to be there the 27th, 28th, 29th. Pulling cars out.
Are we going to North Carolina?
We are.
We are?
Yeah, that's where, the one Yadkin by Linwood.
We have Shannon Morrow. Thank you for the donation, and that's where we're going.
Shannon, thank you very much. Where are you going in North Carolina? Yeah, so Yadkin by Linwood. All right, just go on Craigslist, type in Ford, 5x4.5. Pretty much all Ford patterns will work.
But who are we going to call this late at night?
That's true. That's the thing. And that's what we need right now is we need somebody that's actually awake near Morris, Illinois, that can actually help get us on the road tonight so we can get to Kokomo, Indiana by 9 o'clock in the morning, which is 137 miles away,
yep.
Sam.
Yep.
So that's what we're up against. Yep. But instead of Sam getting on, on Marketplace, he's just eating instead. Hungry, he's so hungry. I gave him so little food today because he's like, hey, just go ahead, show me that again. you just licked the edge of the bowl every last drive. One single oat, okay? You're like, I'm not letting that oat.
That was important to get every single bit here.
Poor Sam's. Today is day one of Super Shred for Sam.
I'm excited.
I'm excited to see what's going to happen.
See what I'll look like.
Are you guys okay? No, we're not really okay. We should be sleeping right now.
Yeah.
And we need to get to Kokomo, Indiana by 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. But because the tire shops are all closed tonight and they don't open until 8 o'clock in the morning, that means we're not going to make it to Kokomo until like noon tomorrow. Yeah. All right. The Craigslist tweakers, haha. Oh, he said that there's some Craigslist tweakers.
Craigslist tweakers are still awake,
I guess. We could get some tweakers and just give them like an extra 20 to go find us some wheels.
There you go.
Yes, call the Craigslist tweakers. Mm-hmm. You got this, Sam. Have you tried the Pilot truck stop? We tried the TA truck stop.
Yeah.
And yeah.
Let me see. I'm going to jump in on the comments here, see what we're missing.
Chris says, I bought you a winch for the channel. What? I was going to talk about Chris. Did you really get me a winch, Chris?
Big Daisy. Big Daisy. Thanks for the donation.
Okay, watch for Chris's comments to come back again. Anyway, so I'm going to crawl underneath the RV here, but Chris was amazing because I tend to do things I shouldn't be doing a lot of times, and I bent the back of trailers before. And so Chris actually took my entire underneath here and he built me a cross member section. And he says that I can like yank like 30,000 pounds now instead of 500. So I'm really excited for that I can actually pull more stuff, because if we end up with viewers that don't show up along the way as we're doing some of these carpools and recoveries and there's no winch on location, I have that yank 'em rope, and I'm sure we're going to do some pretty stupid stuff in the next 38 days.
That's what it's all about here.
Yep.
Sierra Cupcakes, thanks for the donation. I'm not sure what happened to the person that was two blocks away.
What happened? Maybe it was the TA.
Yeah, I'm thinking it was the TA.
Yeah.
That's what they were mentioning.
Yeah, because nobody showed up. Like, I was really excited that somebody was only two blocks away.
Yeah.
No plans for Oklahoma. The backside of the rim should tell you. The backside of the rim should tell us? And because I'm on a live right now. Brandon Larson from childhood friend from Utah. All right, so the back of it, there is negative because, look, Sam toasted the inside of that wheel too. Like that rubber ended up between the wheel and the back wall there. It was quite interesting. Yeah, no markings at all. Semi-truck repair, they have trailer tire spares. Yeah, but that's for small stuff or bigger stuff.
Dilbert said he'll be here in 10 minutes with the tires.
Are you serious? Are you just trying to get airtime again, Jacob?
I think he is. Comment below. Do you think Jacob's just trying to get... Hold on, let me quiet him down. Do you think Jacob's just trying to get airtime, or do you think he's actually being helpful? Comment below, yes or no. Let's take a vote.
10 minutes with three tires.
Three tires? All right, awesome. Hopefully he's right.
Oh.
I hope you're right, Dilbert, because you're going to get me in trouble if you're not.
Who? You Gilbert or Dilbert?
Is it Gilbert or Dilbert?
Dilbert 92.
All right, Dilbert 92. Hope to see you, man.
I think he's just trying to get his name out there, too. He's probably not even showing up. He's like Jacob. Just trying to get some airtime. They're like, oh, you know how I'm going to get a shout out? I'm going to pretend like I'm going to Walmart to take them three tires. No, I really hope it's real.
Hopefully you're coming. We love you. Thanks for the support.
Yes. What's Jacob?
I'm like 6 hours away from you right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, are you really meeting up with us on this trip though?
Jake? 100%.
All right. And you're going to do it in, wait a minute. We had a bet that Jacob was not going to show up tomorrow. Remember he said that he was going to show up in Kokomo, Indiana, and then we bet that he wasn't really going to make it. And
yeah.
Jacob, are you going to be in Kokomo tomorrow with us?
No.
Yeah. Hey, Jacob, remember that time you said you were going to be in Colorado with us?
Yes.
Hey, Jacob, remember that time that you said that you were going to go to Washington and go
hey,
diving
with me,
us?
Hey, man, you're going to go. Uh-huh. He was going to come and live and stay with me on my boat. Yeah. We were going to have a really good time.
Do you think that we should take bets right now? Uh-huh. Comment down below. Do you think that Jacob is actually going to make it to Kentucky with us?
Yeah, comment below. Yes or no. Will Jacob come to Kentucky? Will he keep his word? Is Jacob a man of his word? Will Chaos Divers? Is Chaos Divers a man of his word?
Yeah.
Let's see, Jacob.
Hey, I think that I'm almost out of battery life.
Yeah.
I don't know how much more I have.
It'd be cool if we could hang until the guy pulls in, because if he's really like on his way and he's 10 minutes, I'm sure the viewers would like to see that.
Yeah, hold on. How do I...
I don't know.
Hold on, wait. Let me see if I go this way. Orientation
is locked.
All right,
thanks, Jacob. Appreciate you, brother.
Oh, no problem. Later.
Okay. Hey, I need to also update everybody. I did get the little warning on my phone that says that my battery life is going low, but I can't, because I'm on live, I can't actually tell how many minutes I have. So if it goes dead, I apologize that like the stream suddenly ended. You know that that's the reason why. You know what I'm really impressed with as well?
What's that?
And I don't take this lightly. There's 1,400 viewers on right now.
Yes.
Do you know what that means to me?
That's huge. Could you imagine 1,400 people here just in support? That's pretty much what this is.
That's what this is.
That is, yeah.
Like, we are hanging out in Walmart parking lot.
In an empty parking lot.
Stuck in Morris, Illinois with 1,400
supporting us. That is huge.
That means a lot. Wow. Super, super, duper-dee-duper.
Yeah.
A lot.
That's pretty wild.
Yes. And this thing has been going on now also for 114 minutes. That's almost 2 hours that you have been talking.
Wow.
You know, and some people say, you know, Mr. Lysak or Jared, you talk way too much. I appreciate the 1,400 are here. I don't think they feel like I talk too much. So I really appreciate that you guys do support everything that we do. What else do we want to talk about? I guess I'll start looking at some comments and start answering some more stuff.
Should we go to the RV for a little bit?
No, I'm waiting for the Dilbert to show up.
How drunk are you? We are not drunk. We do not drink.
Yeah. Somebody really asked you that.
I don't know.
Yeah, you know what else? I've also been asked. How much coffee do you have in the morning? I personally have zero coffee.
Yeah, and I can't have it because it gets me feeling weird.
Yeah, I do have energy drinks though, when I'm driving late at night, or I need to be driving late at night, or sometimes before, here's a little secret for you. Sometimes I have a energy drink prior to doing a video to boost my mood and my energy sometimes, just a little bit. And I don't do a full can or anything. And I'll tell you, I drink Reign and not Bang, and there's a reason for it, is because I won't even go into it. Anyway, I have a personal reason to why I won't drink Bang.
I know why.
Yeah. All right. Let me scan back down here.
Plug in your phone, so you can't really.
I can't plug in my phone
We can't plug in the phone because he has his earpiece.
My microphone is broken on this phone. Like if you see my phone, the entire back of it is missing glass and pieces everywhere, and the microphone does not work. And that's why when we were doing the live, when we did the Tim Robinson, I was actually on my phone, and we had audio issues. It's because of this phone. So, eventually someday I'll get a new phone.
Yeah.
All right, Jared, you need a pocket charger for your cell phone. Yeah, except that we've got this.
I'm getting sleepy, though.
Well, you can't get sleepy. You're the one that caused this tonight.
I know, yeah.
Do you get to keep the sponsor gear like the OTS mask? Yes, I do get to keep that. I do not have to send that back. Now, that being said, the boat, we don't have to send back. The Bixby stuff, we don't have to send back. Really, everything that's in the trailer right now, I don't have to send back. Everything that you see that I have, O3, that's 100% mine now. They have taken good care of me. However, the video ray, we do have to send the video ray back. So we have the video ray, the drone that we're picking up on the 30th. We have that for 6 months. There's like a 14-day out clause, like if we put out like a bad video, which I don't think we ever would. But they did want a 14-day out clause if we screw anything up. So anyway, we're really grateful to them because we do get to use that equipment.
Absolutely.
But in reality, I mean, I think it's like $80,000 unit that they're giving us. I know it's at least $45,000. Use Sam's phone. I can't use Sam's phone because then Sam would have all my YouTube login information, and you know he might change my name and delete all my videos. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. What else? Will you ever dive Lake Tahoe? I might. I heard that there was a big cleanup there that just took place. Really clear there. I've been up there, but are we high then? No, we're not high either. We do zero drugs. We did some protein powder today, though.
We did, yeah.
We didn't snort it.
No.
No, not this time. No, we just mixed it in the water. That's it. So
No drugs.
We don't smoke and we don't drink.
Start the stream on Sam's channel when your phone dies.
None of it has anything to do with like any religious reasons. Just want good health is for me. But I'll tell you, the reason why I don't smoke, and I've told you this story before, Kevin Barton and I were little like kindergarten friends at the time. We were five years old, and we got like a whole convoy.
We got a posse coming.
Yeah. I don't think they're here for us, though. So Kevin Barton and I, somebody threw a cigarette down in front of the bank, and we looked at each other and said, "Hey, have you ever smoked?" We're like, "No, I haven't smoked." So we picked it up and took a little puff. And because of that puff, and it was so terrible for me that I never smoked again after that.
Yeah.
And then my drinking story was I was 16. Girlfriend broke up with me that night. We were over at their house. Her stepdad said, "Oh, hey, I know how you feel. There's a six pack out, you know, or a case or whatever out back." So six hams did me in when I was 16 years old, my first drinking experience ever. I hated the taste of it. I've tried different alcohols over the years, just alcohol in general. I don't like the taste of it. I'm a root beer guy. And so anyway, so that's my drinking story. That's my cigarette story. And that's why I don't do either one of those.
Yeah. Good to feel healthy, be nice and clean, good energy.
Yeah.
I actually didn't have my first drink till I was 27.
Yeah. Vicky says that she thinks that Dilbert is a dud too.
Oh, no.
Technically, I think it's only been 8 minutes. So
yeah,
we'll see.
It hasn't been that long.
Rob Landis, how long are you going to be in Kokomo? One day, maybe only half a day now.
Where's your battery at?
My battery?
I mean, your battery life, how much life does it
I have no idea. I can't tell because...
If you die, I might go live on Sam the Adventure Man. So
okay.
If he dies, come run over, Sam the Adventure Man, and I'll pick up where he left off.
That's good. All right, let me look at some other stuff.
How is Tatum and his family doing? I love Tatum.
Yes.
Tatum's awesome.
Spoke with them a couple days ago. In fact, Tatum was also offered to come on this trip. However, he couldn't break away so soon from his wife and kids. So yep, let's see.
Putting his family first, and I have a lot of respect for Tatum. Love you, brother.
Yeah. Jacob says that Dilbert is failing him. I'm guessing that means that Dilbert is not even answering your phone call now, Jacob, or what's going on? I've never dove in Minnesota. Hi from Prineville, Oregon. Hey, Prineville. It's about 20 minutes from my house in Redmond. I watched a film not long ago. If it turns up a VW bus, he's got a rocket runner. I don't know what that means. Are you coming to Iowa? Wesley, we were in Iowa just a few hours ago. We were in Hampton, Iowa.
Hampton.
Looking for Ethan. There's a $100,000 reward if you can find him. The video comes out that we did next Friday showing you all the locations that Ethan is not. So it's a real live treasure hunt. You find Ethan, you get yourself $100,000. Now, Wesley, should you go find him based upon all the locations that we showed you that he is not? Think about at least like a little, 20%, marketing cut or something, okay? Because we could definitely use it, especially on some new tires tonight, Sam.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Totally.
All right.
Well, I don't know about that. I don't know about Dilbert.
Yeah, we have quite a few people calling a TA truck stop, evidently. So we really appreciate that.
Yeah. So if you guys
don't call TA anymore in Missouri.
Give the lady a break. Everyone's been calling and they don't have it. So thank you guys for your support. Thank you for trying on our behalf.
Yes. Michelle, that was up at the lake with us, just subscribed to your channel. So
yeah, I'm getting
thank
a lot of subs.
That.
Thanks, guys. I'll be posting a lot of stuff from our adventures and some other adventures here in the future. So I appreciate you guys coming over.
Yep. Byron says 30, or Brian says 32 years of recovery and 8 years off the cigs. Congratulations
nice,
for that.
Nice. Good job. That's huge.
Yep. Live stream on computer. It won't bump over to the computer though, and then my computer is going to die. And
Elite Towing. We love Elite Towing. They're not here though.
Yeah. Where is he? Anything going to happen in New Jersey? Nothing at this time in Jersey. Nobody gave me any actual targets. So if I had targets, so then we could have put it on our list. So maybe we'll take another trip in, maybe February would be a good time to take another trip. Where to after this rescue? Kimberly Hart, we're going to Kokomo, to Pennsylvania, to a homicide up in Vermont, to a missing persons down in North Carolina, to another missing persons over in Nashville, Tennessee. Well, we have a lot. Here's the thing. Just make sure you're subscribed. A lot of things are happening. Videos are happening every single week right now in October. In November, as we get towards the holiday season, we're going to start dropping 2 to 3 videos a week during Thanksgiving week. And then also during Christmas, we're gonna drop a few extra videos every week as well. So we're shooting between 25 and 30 videos in the next 38 days. Like we don't have any time off. Like
Darren Dudding, 17 years alcohol free, man. That's awesome. Yeah. So congratulations on that.
Absolutely, 100%. And so we have zero time off. Like this is a working, helping people.
Yes, absolutely.
Is what this is.
I don't even know how to say this name here. Socien?
S-O-S-E-N?
Yeah. Hello from Quebec. Thank you. Hello to you. Thanks for the donation.
Thank you very much. I don't know when I'm going to die over here. We've been.
Yeah, but as soon as his phone dies, you come over to my live stream. I'll start picking up where he left off. Sam, the Adventure Man. Come check me out.
All right. Are you ever coming to Nevada? I don't think there's really anything in Nevada to dive. Yeah, I know there's like the bomber in Lake Mead, but
Lake Mead.
I mean, our thing is about trying to help people right now. Like that's what we're really addicted to. If Dilbert doesn't show up, Chaos Divers put him in timeout. Are you ever coming to Nevada? I have the exact tire, but I'm in California. Doesn't help.
That's a little fur.
Yeah. Why don't you just go check the nearest river loads of tires there?
Right.
Yes. Nearest river loads. Yes. Okay. Yes, you are correct. Lots of tires there. Because I need rims as well, because Sam ruined the rim. Like, he destroyed that rim. Thanks, Sam.
Yeah, there was sparks and flames and all kinds of excitement.
Yeah. All right, here we go. All right. Okay, bye-bye, tire. All right, what else we got? Dilbert got lost. Is Dilbert still coming, Jacob? Like, is he lost or is he just not coming? Tyler says he just subscribed to your channel. Oh, I have 10% battery remaining.
10%? That's pretty good.
So we're still doing good.
Yeah, we're still doing good.
So we
good.
Probably have like 5 more minutes at least. Hi from Tigard, Oregon.
The guy.
Ever coming to Connecticut? I forget where Connecticut's at. Help.
Yeah, I was skipping school that day.
I think it's over by West Virginia, isn't it? So we're going to be passing through West Virginia. Is that where Connecticut's at?
I don't know. I just, yeah.
Will you be by St. Louis? I think we're going to be through St. Louis, but we're not stopping St. Louis this time. Come to Australia. I would love to come to Australia.
Come to Australia.
Except your country is shut down. And for that reason, I can't travel there. So I plan on going with Dan Under Dan. That was my plan in October. All right. Have you guys ever been to Michigan? No diving there. Who in Nashville are you going to be searching for? His name is, I don't know his last name, but his name is Will or Bill. And his wife is Christine. And the story was he was working for 38 years, but eventually unemployment as well as his job said you cannot work anymore. The pain was so great that he left the house that morning, not wearing his shoes. His wife says that he was like, he couldn't drive more than like a mile without his shoes. He was in so much pain. So he left all his medication. He left his shoes. He left his wallet. He went for a short drive that morning. In fact, I think he might have even gone shirtless, Sam.
Oh, really?
I don't know about the shirt. Three cars have been identified in the river at the boat ramp near his house about a quarter mile away. So we are going over there.
Sam, what is the best way to not sink a boat? It's to keep the water on the outside. That's the answer to that.
There's a vehicle coming. Is this Dilbert?
Sherry K.
No, that's not Dilbert.
Thanks for the big donation. Appreciate you.
Sherry.
Okay, that's awesome.
Buy a rim. LOL, you guys are awesome. Much love. Be safe, Sherry. Thank you very much. It's going to help us out for sure. We just need to find out where we can get the rim.
What's Dan doing?
She totally took care of you. Like, that should have been your responsibility.
Thanks, Sherry. I appreciate you.
Yes.
That way I don't have to pay for it.
Well, that was an easy out for you.
Appreciate it. Thank you. It's awesome.
I should still make you take care of it.
Right.
All right.
Let's go see what Dan's doing.
What is Dan doing?
I don't know.
He probably fell asleep.
What do you guys think? Well, Dan's like 18 years old. So you think he's awake or you think he's sleeping?
Yeah.
Let's go find out.
All right. How many hours do you think you have dived? Oh, I have don't. You know, I don't even track my dives anymore, Dusk Night. So I don't know how many hours I've... How many hours do you think you've dove?
I stopped yes. counting. We called AAA, by the way. They would only tow. They won't help us.
Yeah.
You got another question. But yeah, I stopped logging my dives a long time ago.
Oh, I was right. Connecticut is pretty close to Vermont. Why don't you guys come see us in Connecticut? We don't have time to just hang out and socialize. This is like a really big working trip. Is he sleeping?
No, he's...
He's not even here. Dude, we lost Dan.
Hey, maybe those people that came by in that creepy van, maybe they kidnapped him.
No, that's not funny. People get kidnapped all the time. Dan, are you in here?
Hey, Dan.
Oh, wait. Is this him over here? Is that you, Dan?
Yeah, it's Dan.
Okay, good. We were worried you got kidnapped.
Yeah, so we still have Dan.
Okay.
We haven't lost Dan.
Well.
In case his mother's watching. Yes. We haven't lost your son.
We did meet his mom. His mom came up from Florida to Colorado and dropped him off.
Hello from San Antonio, Texas. That's where I was born. Hello back.
There's a trailer place that will be open at 9 a.m. Yeah, and yes. Yeah, that's our like backup plan, Tim. But we're hoping to, Dilbert. We're hoping that Dilbert is a real person that will actually be here.
I'm thinking not.
I'm thinking not either. I'm thinking Dilbert was just trying to get his name out there.
Yeah, just crying wolf, getting our hopes up.
Thanks, Dilbert.
Yeah, man. You just...
Probably not even his real name. Probably his real name is probably like Philbert or something.
Yeah, or Phil with an F.
All right, somebody said that Dan was eating. No, Dan was on the phone.
Where did you recover the snowcat, Jared?
Island Lake, Grand Mesa, Colorado. It's about 4.5, almost 5 hours from Denver, 90 minutes from Grand Junction.
Hi from South Korea.
Hello, South Korea. Somebody thought he might be in a pizza coma. I could agree with that. I would put money on that one.
I'd love a pizza coma.
Yeah. Oh, so you said we have to solve the disappearance of Dan. We solved it. All done.
Yeah, missing case.
Uh-huh. He walked pretty far away at one point. Wheelboat is forward, 4.5. Help find Waldo. Help find Dano.
Dano, there we go. Where's Dano?
Yeah.
Where's I like it.
Yeah. He's looking for Dilbert.
Yeah, I think so.
Jared has sent you an email with my friend's number that lives 2.5 hours from you right now. He will for sure have the wheel and can help. Is your friend awake at midnight? Somebody might be coming at 2 or 3 in the morning too.
Yeah.
If we're sleeping and you're on, it was Colette, right? Or Colleen.
I don't remember the name. This is the RV.
Yeah. Knock. Yeah. Just knock.
Do you guys have any dive tattoos? I am a rebel. I have no tattoos.
I also don't have any tattoos. Never did get one. My wife, if she's still on, girls, comment if you're still on, or send me a text. Tell me if you're still on. Kristen actually has a single tattoo.
Yeah.
And she wanted a butterfly. It's a butterfly tattoo. Huh? And she carried around a picture of this butterfly that she thought that she might want a tattoo of for 5 years.
Oh, wow. Five years.
And she went into multiple tattoo places over the years. And finally she walked into one and she's like, yeah, I've been carrying this around for 5 years. He's like, you sit down right now because we're done carrying it around. And she got a butterfly tattoo.
Yeah, my girlfriend, she has tattoos also. Yeah. My girlfriend has some really nice ones. I like them.
Yeah.
But I'm a needle phobic, so.
Yeah, I don't like, yeah. I mean, I get blood though. Blood regularly.
He told me he gives blood and it makes him feel like rejuvenated.
Yes.
Because it takes all the old blood away and his body creates new blood.
Yes.
And so it's fresh. And I'm kind of a little squeamish.
Yeah. So a couple things with giving blood. Yeah. One is I hate giving blood, but they used to actually give you like real good treats back in the day, like, you know, like homemade cookies and stuff like that and cheese. I'm up to over 80 pints now. I'm only 20 away from my lifetime goal of 100 pints.
Wow.
I've been giving blood a long time.
That's a lot.
And in addition to that, as Sam was saying, I initially didn't end up doing it to help people. I had selfish reasons. 100% truth, because it's like an oil change for guys, because guys don't menstruate. And so for that reason, it's like an oil change for us. And I think that that's why my skin has a younger complexion to it. So, you know, I'm 45, by the way. I just celebrated my 45th birthday.
Yeah, I'm apparently 75.
Yes.
By my BMI chart thing that we did earlier today.
The truckers across the way at the TA and stuff cannot help us because we've actually called over there. So.
Blue Lightning, Sam, what is the biggest boat you got?
Wait, before you get into that, R. Warren, $100 for some new tires or pizza for Dan.
Thank you.
No, tires for sure. Dan's not getting any more pizza. Maybe we'll get him a pizza.
Maybe.
Yes.
Anyway, Blue Lightning, Sam, what is the biggest boat you got? A boat that I've rescued or my boat personally? So I'll try to keep an eye out for your response to what I just asked.
All right. Let's see. Dilbert, 69, is lost. Not the same as diving for cars, but I find stolen cars. Ask the truckers. Happy birthday. Filbert needs a better GPS.
Dilbert's not coming? Yeah, we kind of figured
we figured that one out.
He's a fake.
Yeah.
So Jacob just told me that Dilbert isn't coming, and it's actually a dummy account that he owns, and he was just trying to get our hopes up.
Oh, Jacob created the dummy account?
Thanks, Jacob.
Oh, and he's
No, I'm joking. Not really.
Don't blame that on me.
Yes, Natalie, for real. I am 45, just celebrated my 25th anniversary with Kristen, my wife as well. And we have two children, 20 and 23. The girls hate it when I say how old they are. I don't know why, but yeah. Kiki, the camera girl, 23. Kiki, all right, and Malia, and we call her Maliki Liki Laka. And sometimes we even sing. That's right. Yeah. On a sweet Hawaiian
Christmas
day, something like that. Yeah. I don't know exactly how it goes. So that's my girls are 20 and 23. And my wife still looks like she's 18 and that she's one of the girls' sisters.
There you go, yeah.
I think it's the water that we grew up on, but I'm not sure.
Yeah. My kids are 20, 13, and 12.
Yeah.
And my girlfriend's son is 10. So.
It's awesome that you give blood. I might save someone's life. 12 years sober. Okay. Dilbert's a liar for sure. Dilbert.
I see you, Blue Lightning.
Dilbert is a liar. We're not even going to say the word Dilbert anymore.
No. Yeah. So
who gets lost on the way to Walmart? That's right. Right, Big Daisy? I agree with you. Hey, thank you, Big Daisy, also for being a member. Those of you who are not members, you do get videos early, except for the snowcat video. I apologize. You who are members are not getting the snowcat video early. In fact, I still got to go upload that tonight. Oh,
snowcat video?
Yes.
Yeah, he has to do that so you guys can watch it in the morning.
Yes.
Now, Blue Lightning, the biggest boat I recovered was 73 feet, and it was huge, and I had to recover it with a 28-foot Crozier craft. So it was nearly, I mean, it was just this ginormous, massive yacht, but we got him in safe and secure, and everything was great.
Yep. On that note, I'm down to like 3% here. Looks like it's going to die. So how about if we do this? Jacob, throw up Sam's YouTube link one more time, and we're going to jump over to Sam's YouTube right now. So that way we can keep this show going. And I'm going to plug this phone in because I'll be able to undo the headphones. And then I'm going to start uploading the snowcat video. It's over 10 gigabytes that I have to upload.
How do you create this?
Oh, so first of all, here, you
take that.
Yeah, what you do. And so you have to create a title. So what do you want your title to be?
Jared's teaching me, by the way.
Yep. So what are we going to call this one? We're going to call this Stuck.
Stuck
in Morris, right?
Yeah.
Morris with Adventures with Purpose. How about we do that? Adventures with Purpose. Okay?
Perfect.
We're doing public. Location doesn't matter. Audience. What's that going to be here? More options.
Yeah,
next,
so we're
next.
Setting up the live right now.
Okay, so I think that's going to work. And then we have to take a picture also.
All right, this should be the picture.
Yep. Hold on, wait. Next. Oh, what, why is it not going? What did I do wrong?
I don't know what you did.
I'm no good at this YouTube stuff. Learn more options. Advanced settings, next.
I always ask Jacob.
No, we don't want to schedule for later. Wait, are you not allowed to do lives? Do you not have enough? No, you have enough subscribers.
No. I've done live.
Allow chat. No, it doesn't. Enable monetization. No. Jacob, you can't call us. We're trying to get this set up.
Maybe let's back out. I think you go to.
That's on public.
So we're on public.
Uh-huh. Do we have to add a description? Stuck.
Stuck. All right. We'll try this. Because I think you have to. All right.
Okay, done. Now can we, no, it won't let us go next. What are we missing on this?
I think you have to, you'll say it's
audience?
Not for kids. I think I do the audience.
Audience.
There it is.
No, there we go. It's not made for kids.
I think we're ready now.
Now, okay. Right. Now we got to take a picture. Hold on.
Ready? And one. Two. Keep your hand.
Okay. All right. Do we do it? All right, now go live.
Go live.
All right. I think you might.
Whoa!
Yes, you're live now.
I wonder what happens if you go like that. You put them.
Uh-huh.
How do you flip your phone around?
All right, so now.
I'm curious.
Oh, I don't know. Can you flip it around?
I wonder if you can do like a little thing. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Then it's going to create like a time warp.
Yeah, like a little vortex. Uh-huh. You can do the vortex.
Woo!
Awesome.
All right. So everybody jump over to. Boy, that's facing me now. So
Sam the Adventure Man.
Everybody jump over to Sam the Adventure Man. Head
over
there right now.
Sam the Adventure Man.
I can't go to bed yet, Lauren. And the reason why is because I have to go upload the snowcat video and I have to have it ready in, I don't know, like 5 hours. It's probably going to take 2.5 hours at least to upload because I'm on a Wi-Fi hotspot right now.
Yeah.
So thank you, everybody. I really appreciate all of you for hanging out for, how long has it been? 139 minutes they've been hanging out with us so far. Because you gave us a flat tire.
Yeah, I gave us a reason to stop and hang out.
So thank you very much. I'm signing off of this feed. Jump over right now to Sam the Adventure Man. You can follow me inside because I gotta start.
Yeah, let's go.
But let's lock this up as well. So anyway, that's it for me. Later. Bye-bye. See you over on Sam's channel. Bye-bye. All right. So.
All right, guys. We're just going to.